From Titan Gym in Fullerton, California, the Prime Ticket Network presents exciting Big West basketball. Tonight, the UNLV Running Rebels tangle with the Cal State Fullerton Titans. Hello, everybody. This is Mike Walden. Welcome to Fullerton, California, in tonight's UNLV Fullerton game. This is the seventh year that UNLV has been a member of the Big West Conference. Used to be the old PCAA. One word describes UNLV in basketball in this league, and that is domination. The Rebels have won the league championship six straight years. UNLV's record 107-10 in this conference. And it's the same story again this season. The Rebels are on top of the Big West Conference standings, 10-1. New Mexico State is second. Santa Barbara and Fresno State are tied for third. Utah State is next in line. You will notice that Fullerton has a record of 4-6 in eighth place in the Big West Conference, an overall mark of 9-10. But the Titans lost by only 3 points in mid-January to UNLV in Las Vegas. Our colleague on the telecast tonight is the former head coach at Kansas, Ted Owens. Ted, it's an amazing story about Fullerton. They have been close so many times against UNLV, but they haven't beaten the Rebels in 6 years.
But it was on this court 6 years ago that Leon Woods led his team to an 86-78 victory.
And the Fullerton Titans are hoping that that magic strikes again 6 years later. UNLV has a 15-5 overall mark, and the Rebels are ranked 19th in the nation. And they've been getting some great, superb play from a 6'7 sophomore, Stacy Augment. He has been outstanding.
Well, Stacy's always been a great defensive player, but he's really improved his offensive skills. Look at the great move that Stacy made there with his left hand.
Yes, and look at those long arms. No wonder he scores so well. Augment had 29 points and 13 rebounds in that loss at UC Irvine Saturday night. The big gun for the Titans of Fullerton, none other than Cedric Sabalos. He is a 6'7 junior. Sabalos is the number one scorer in the Big West Conference.
A very versatile basketball player. Look at his move inside. That's where he's best, in the open court.
He's averaging better than 21 points a game. And in that first meeting against UNLV, Sabalos had 31 points and 13 rebounds. And if the Titans are going to win here tonight, they need another big game like that from Sabalos.
You bet. Sabalos is an absolute must. Another must for them is Fullerton must handle the pressure defense of UNLV.
One thing that Fullerton will have going for them tonight, a sellout crowd here at Titan Gym, 4,000. We'll be back with the starting lineups of this Big West Conference game from Titan Gym in Fullerton, California.
I'll get it, Alex.
Mel's Market. Here's your order.
What order?
Side of beef.
I didn't order.
Here's your delivery, sir.
What delivery?
Your Stroh's 30 packs.
Stroh's? Alex?
Nah.
Stroh's and Stroh Light. Fire brewed for smooth, consistent taste. And with 30 packs, you get more beer.
Pardon. Pierre's Pet Shop. Here's your poodle.
Oh. Alex.
Kretzky, all alone, in front, he shoots, he scores!
Attention fans, the Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers proudly announced the On the Road with the Kings contest. You could win a new Mitsubishi Mighty Max 4x4 truck, courtesy of your Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers. You'll also join the Los Angeles Kings on a road trip when they battle the New Jersey Devils and New York Rangers in late February. You'll fly round trip to New York, courtesy of today's TWA. Find out how good they are to New York. And stay at the beautiful Sheraton Center provided by Sheraton, the hospitality people of ITT. To enter, fill out the entry form available at your participating Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers, or send your name, address, and phone number on a postcard to On the Road with the Kings, 401 South Prairie, Suite 104, Inglewood, California, 90301. Entries must be received by February 15th.
Nichols to Duchesne, he scores!
Don't get shut out. Break away to your participating Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers and enter today.
A performance you won't forget. Ford Probe GT.
Have you driven a Ford lately?
A
sellout crowd of 4,000 here at Titan Gym, and every nook and cranny is packed for UNLV and Fullerton. Let's meet the starting lineups. For that, we go to the public address announcer, Mark Helmer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Titan Gymnasium for tonight's Big West Conference basketball game between the Runnin' Rebels of Nevada, Las Vegas, and the Titans of Cal State Fullerton. Now let's meet the starters for tonight's contest, beginning at forward for the Runnin' Rebs, 6'7", 192, a sophomore from Pasadena, California, number 32, Stacy Ogman. At forward for the Titans, 6'7", 210, a senior out of Long Beach, wearing number 23, Derek Jones. At the other forward spot for Las Vegas, 6'10", 200, a junior out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 44, George Eccles. For the Titans, at the other forward spot, 6'7", 190, a junior out of Los Angeles, number 31, Cedric Sabalos. For the Runnin' Rebs at center, 6'10", 200, a junior out of Washington, D.C., 00, David Butler. At the center position for the Titans, 6'8", 210-pound junior from Omaha, Nebraska, number 52, David Moody. At guard for the Runnin' Rebs, 6'2", 199, a senior from Las Vegas, number 22, Clint Rossum. At guard for the Titans, he's 6'1", 160-pound freshman from Los Angeles, number 10, Wayne Williams. At the other guard spot for the Runnin' Rebs, he's 6'1", 188-pound sophomore from Los Angeles, number 50, Greg Anthony. And for the Titans at the other guard spot, 6'3", 180, a junior from Los Angeles, number 44, Mark Hill. The Runnin' Rebs are coached by Jerry Tarkanian in his 16th season, assisted by Tim Gurewicz, Howie Landa, and Keith Starr. For the Titans, it's John Sneed in his 9th year with the university, first year as head coach, assisted by Donnie Daniels and David Grossman. The trainer is Jerry Lloyd. The series stands 20-2 in favor of UNLV.
Tarkanian has donned glasses in the last week or so, and I guess he's done more for the optometry business in Las Vegas than any other single action.
He's probably needed them for a long time, but just was too vain.
Well, Tark is 58 years old now. Hard to believe, but this is his 16th year as the head coach at UNLV. His 21st year on the major collegiate coaching level. And he has 516 victories, only 111 defeats. Although they did lose last Saturday night at the Bryn Center on the UC Irvine campus, came right back and beat Santa Barbara, and beat up on Santa Barbara pretty good, 77-61. Terry Tackett is the referee. He's the dean of students at Oxnard Union High School. Rich Ballesteros will be the umpire, and Brent Smith of Sandy, Utah, the other umpire. Terry Tackett, the dean of students up at Oxnard, is superintendent, Dr. Bob Carter, and the principal is Don Bathgate. They have a very fine school up there and a good athletic tradition. It'll be interesting to see how Sabalos fares tonight, because I know he's going to be a marked man due to the fact that he had 31 points and 13 rebounds in that 66-63 loss to the Rebels in Las Vegas mid-January.
I think that Jerry Tarkanian will probably put his ace defender, Stacy Ogman, on Sabalos from the beginning.
We're ready to go. Everybody standing here at Titan Gym on the Cal State Fullerton campus in Fullerton, California. And it'll be David Butler at 6'10", jumping for UNLV, and Derek Jones, who is just 6'7", but he can jump and jump very well for Fullerton. Controlled by Eccles for UNLV to Rossum. Puts up a 10-footer. It's kicked out, and right away we got a foul underneath against UNLV.
Jerry Tarkanian, his great pressure defense was most effective in the first outing. Fullerton had 27 turnovers, 20 in one half at Las Vegas, and yet they only lost by 3 points.
The foul was on Stacy Augman, who was fouled out 5 times this season. Ackles has fouled out 9 times for UNLV. But Augman picked up the personal first one of the game. Mark Hill gets it over to Sabalos. 15-footer by Cedric, right through, and Fullerton jumps to an early 2-zip lead.
Cedric Sabalos is much better.
And right away, the ball off of the fingertips of Clint Rossum out of bounds. And let's see if now if the Titans will be able to capitalize against Jerry Tarkanian's team.
Cedric Sabalos much more effective against man-for-man defense, even though he does have Stacy Augman guarding him.
It would behoove Fullerton to get off to a good start, a capacity crowd. And on the drive, Sabalos is fouled.
Again, Stacy Augman, this early in the ballgame, Stacy Augman is going to pick up his second foul. Penetration by Cedric Sabalos, and Augman just trails him and reaches in, and that's his second foul.
We've played 45 seconds of this game, and Stacy Augman, the number one scorer for Jerry Tarkanian's team, averaging just under 15 a game, has 2 personal fouls.
And Jerry just told him to switch men.
And it's 3-0 on the free throw by Sabalos. So the score is Cedric Sabalos 3 and Jerry Tarkanian and UNLV nothing. Tarkanian will let that tie out another notch.
Well, he's very concerned about Stacy Augman being in foul trouble. He's his most effective basketball player.
Butler for UNLV to Greg Anthony. It was Anthony who beat Fullerton in a buzzer beater the final 3 seconds.
Yeah, very bad shot selection by Greg Anthony. UNLV needs to become a little bit more stable here. They've picked up a couple of early fouls, and the last thing that Jerry Tarkanian needed was for Greg Anthony to put the ball up at that range.
Williams gives the ball off to Moody. Moody back over to Mark Hill. Hill back over to Jones. Williams lets her fly. Wayne Williams off the side. No, and here comes UNLV with it. A steal. Williams with the steal for Fullerton, and there is a great block by George Ackles. I mean to tell you, Ackles skied to fly swat that shot away.
This is George Ackles is one of the finest shot blockers in the Big West Conference. Interception by Wayne Williams. Good anticipation as he penetrates. It looks like he has a basket, but look at Ackles.
Sabalos has it rejected by Ackles again. That's 2 blocked shots by George Ackles already. Ackles says, look, you come into my area, you're treading on heavy water here.
Well, this is big man's territory in there.
3-0, Fullerton. This gym is a very cozy little gym, holding only 4,000. The people, the stands come right down to the edge of the floor as you look at John Sneed in his first year at Fullerton, taking over after George McCorn resigned the 1st of November, just 2 weeks before the season's opener. Sneed's done a nice job with this team.
Oh, I think he has.
Here is Jones, has it rejected this time, and they're gonna call goaltending. Goaltending against George Ackles. So the basket will go to Derrick Jones. It's 5-0 Fullerton.
Good penetration by Jones. It had started its downward arc when Ackles hit the ball.
If it had been on the upward arc, that would have been a clean block. 5-0 Titans.
Matchup zone. Fullerton's going right away to their matchup zone.
Rossum feeds down to Ackles, and it's knocked away from George Ackles, and the foul is whistled against David Moody of the Titans, his first.
Got good penetration with the basketball. Dwight Moody just found himself out of position, reached in and hacked him.
George Ackles, 6'10 junior out of Pittsburgh, will shoot a pair. Ackles is not a good free throw shooter. He is 47% at the line.
Las Vegas is not a good free throw shooting team, and he's the worst of all of them.
That's
they only
right.
shoot 62%, I believe.
And that's the worst in the Big West Conference. 5-1 on the free throw by Ackles. Spent 2 years of JC ball at Garden City Junior College in Kansas. And Brent Smith has the call. He says it'll be out of bounds to UNLV. Inbounding it will be Greg Anthony. 5-1 Fullerton.
zone defense.
And Butler puts up the shot, and it goes through. I think it would have gone through anyway, but the referee, Terry Tackett, immediately called goaltending against Fullerton.
Yes, Fullerton hit it while it was on the rim.
So it's a 5-3 contest. The Titans of Cal State Fullerton leading the University of Nevada, Las Vegas. Ceballos off to Mark Hill. He tries a three-pointer. Yes, Mark Hill! 8-3, Cal State Fullerton.
Fullerton is not a good outside shooting team, but Mark Hill has a very good percentage in shooting three-point range.
Rossum lays it off to Butler, and Butler is fouled. Ceballos got him. Cedric Ceballos.
Clint Rossum is a very good ball handler. Nice penetration, good feed off to David Butler, and they hacked him as he went up. Moody reached in and hacked him. Probably a good foul, though he's not a particularly good free throw shooter.
Butler, as he toes the mark, is a 64% free throw shooter.
I don't think that defensively you should ever let Las Vegas shoot a layup, as poor a free throw shooting team as they are. Unless you're in foul trouble, I think you should reach in and hack them.
A change. Jerry Tarkanian inserts Anderson Hunt into the lineup, replacing Clint Rossum. This will be the second free throw for Butler. And he gets that one to drop. So it's an 8-4 lead for Fullerton. We've played 2.5 minutes of this game. Fullerton 9-10 overall, 4-6 in the league, and UNLV 15-5, 10-1 in the Big West Conference.
Three-quarter court man-for-man pressure. Anderson Hunt reached in and knocked the ball out of bounds.
Jerry Tarkanian looks different in those glasses.
Looks distinguished, don't you think?
Yes, he does. 8-4. Fullerton leading UNLV in the early going here at Titan Gym. Mike Walden and Ted Owens along the prime ticket network. Jones doesn't get it to drop, but it looks like, or it appeared, that somebody might have interfered when that ball was in the cylinder. Anderson Hunt for UNLV. In it goes to Butler, kicks it out over to Greg Anthony. Inside pass to Ackles, tapped away by Moody, down to Mark Hill. Hill pulls up, takes the shot, doesn't get it. Follow up, Ceballos. Cedric Ceballos, 10-4, Fullerton. Butler may have traveled off to Hunt. Hunt doesn't get it. Follow up by Butler. Yes, David Butler. I think Butler got away with steps.
He very well could have.
10-6 the score. Fullerton leading UNLV.
Butler is just getting better and better all the time.
Ceballos goes for the baseline, the 10-footer. In again, Cedric Ceballos with 7 points. 7 of the 12 by Fullerton. It's a 12-7 lead for the Titans.
Well, he was able to get good, tough double team. Mark Hill and Wayne Williams, good, tough double team, but they reached in and fouled.
Foul number one on Mark Hill, third team foul against Fullerton. And Moody over there talking with John Sneed, the head coach at Fullerton. Moody goes to the bench, John Sykes in to replace Moody. It's a 12-6 lead for Fullerton. Butler's five-footer. No. Grabbed off by Stacy Augman. And Augman doesn't score it, but Augman is fouled, which will send Stacy Augman to the free throw line for UNLV.
Mike, there's a theory in basketball that one team's aggressive on defense, the other must measure up to that aggressiveness. I think that John Sneed has been troubled by Vegas's defensive pressure, and so he says we're just going to go pressure them, and it's had good effect.
Foul is on Derrick Jones, his second, and it's the fourth team foul against Fullerton. And UNLV continues to have a tough time at the free throw line. And Tark is chewing on the towel this early. We haven't even played 5 minutes.
He's really concerned with their free throw shooting. He told me before the game, if they had shot just a decent percentage, that they'd have won about 3 more ball games this year, maybe both the Oklahoma games.
Augman puts in the second free throw to make it 12-7. So we have played about 4 minutes of this first half, and it's a 5-point lead for Cal State Fullerton.
Cruiser War 89. Six fantastic cruiserweight matchups. NABF champ Smokin' Bert Cooper defends his title against Nate Mr. Miller. And battling for top ranking, see two-time world champ Wright Muhammad Kawe. The superstar of Africa, Nigerian national champ Bashiru Ali. Courageous Craig Bojanowski. It's a pay-per-view event. February 15th, Cruiser War 89.
This Valentine's Day, home is where the heart is with fine gifts from the Home Shopping Club. Give your Valentine a sterling silver CZ pendant at a price you'll love, just $39.75. Tell her you'd like a gold-tone nugget watch by Gruen. She'll love the price, just $99. You'll both love the club price of this stunning 14-karat gold amethyst and diamond ring, just $186.75. Home is where the heart is. This Valentine's Day on TV's Home Shopping Club.
Tonight's game is brought to you by Great Western's family of companies with over $32 billion in assets. 100 years strong. We'll always be there. And by Stroh's and Stroh's Light. Now you're talking good times, and Stroh's is spoken here. Ted Owens, let me pick up on something you said right before that break about the poor free throw shooting by UNLV. 62%, worst in the league. UNLV has a record of 15-5. And four of those five losses have been to teams in the top seven. They lost to Arizona, to Oklahoma twice. And what was the other loss? Help me.
Oklahoma twice. Yep. Louisville.
Louisville. I forgot about Louisville. But you're right. They've lost so many close games, and three of their five losses have been by 2 points or less. So, boy, that free throw shooting really comes back to haunt you. Ackles with a jam. George Ackles. That makes it 12-9.
George found a seam in the zone and just went to the hole.
3 points for Ackles. Fullerton shooting very well. 50% from the field on 5 out of 10. Wayne Williams sees a little daylight. Off to Jones.
Las Vegas.
Zabalos. Oh, what a half Cedric Zabalos is having. 9 points already in the game, and a foul against Wayne Williams of the Titans.
The games this year in which Cedric Zabalos has been most effective have been against man-for-man defensive teams. I don't believe there's a better one-on-one player in the Big West Conference than Cedric Zabalos.
There isn't a better scorer. The latest stats that Jody McRoberts put out this week show him right up there on top. Zabalos averaging 21.3.
And just as impressive, his rebounding has been excellent. He's second in the league in rebounding. Could become the first player in the Big West to be the leading scorer and rebounder since Sidney Green in 1983.
Anthony shot a little bit short. A follow-up. Ackles. Ackles with a thunderous in-your-face slam dunk.
That's their best game, rebounding. Stick backs.
Mark Hill brings it up against Hunt. They try to trap him at the midcourt line. Off to Wayne Williams.
Fullerton has not been had too much bad effect out of their rebound.
Mark Hill puts in the three-pointer. Mark Hill. He's 2 out of 2 in three-point shots. Hill was fouled. He could make it a four-point basket.
Well, Mark Hill shooting 45% from the three-point range this year. A very good percentage.
Barry Young into the UNLV lineup, replacing Stacy Augman. Augman picked up two personal fouls in less than a minute to start this game. Hill makes it 18-11. Cal State Fullerton over the 19th-ranked team in the United States UNLV. There's the alley-oop over to Ackles. Ackles can't find the handle. Young gets it back over to Anthony.
Great play by Anthony.
The basket will count.
No.
Well, one official said that it would. Terry Tackett, the referee, said the basket will count. Richie Ballesteros says no. Now, let's get this sorted out.
Greg Anthony penetrated to the basket, laid it up, made a great play. The ball was going down, no question about it. But the Butler came in from the side and hit the rim while it was still in the cylinder.
And Tackett, the referee, could not see that, and immediately Richie Ballesteros, who had the better angle, he could see it, and he said no because of that. And the officials working very well with one another.
He was right on top of the play.
UNLV, 3 out of 7 at the free throw line, 4 out of 8 now as Anthony puts it in. 18-12, Cal State Fullerton.
Williams and Hill have handled the defensive pressure by Las Vegas very well.
Williams off to Sykes.
Sykes a great rebounder. Not much of a score, but an excellent rebound.
Williams puts it in. 2 points. An 18-footer by Wayne Williams. 20-12, Cal State Fullerton. Butler shot. Yes, right on a line. A line drive 5-footer by David Butler. 20-14, Fullerton over UNLV. Good first half. We played less than 6.5 minutes, and good scoring on the part of both teams, and a good start by Fullerton. Jones! Derrick Jones, 22-14.
Well, Jerry Tarkanian's bread and butter is that man-for-man defense, but they're about a half step behind tonight, and Fullerton's really sharp.
Brent Smith has got the foul underneath. And the foul is going to be against Fullerton.
Moody coming in for Sykes. John Sneed is rotating his centers to keep one fresh all the time.
David Moody is in, and Sykes will go out. That is the 7th team foul against Fullerton. 3 team fouls against UNLV, and Augman has 2 out of the 3.
Well, and that has really altered his game. He's lost his aggressiveness. He does not want to pick up the third foul early in this half.
David Butler, the 6'10 junior from Washington, D.C., is at the line. And the Rebels continue to have problems at the foul line. Traveling, no basket. They take it away from George Ackles. And the score remains 22-14. Tarkanian's team down by 8. Against Cal State Fullerton here at Titan Gym.
I couldn't see his feet inside. He turned and squared, did a very good job, but the official was on top of the play, had a better angle than I did.
UNLV going with Stacy Sionovich, David Butler, Greg Anthony, George Ackles, and Ray Young, and we will get a timeout. 13:27 left in the first half, an 8-point lead for Fullerton.
How will you live in the next century? Suddenly, life will be more comfortable, smoother, and quicker. Introducing the new 1989 Buick Century, with premium features you expect from the best-selling Buick on the American road. All at a price that will let you enter the next century very comfortably.
The great American road belongs to Buick.
Clear day. You can see Mount Shasta 100 miles away. Sure makes everything else look mighty small. Kind of like Great Western Bank, big and strong. You see, nowadays, the Great Western family of companies stands for over $32 billion in assets and the security of federal insurance. They've been keeping folks' money safe for 100 years now. So you know Great Western's gonna be there for a long time to come. For sheer size and strength, it sure stands out.
Tomorrow night, Prime Ticket brings you exciting hockey action as the Kings are back east to face the Washington Capitals. Prime Ticket's coverage starts at 6 o'clock. The Kings and Prime Ticket, sports television at its best. UNLV, 5 out of 10 from the floor, 50%, but Tark's going to take another bite out of that towel. Fullerton, on the other hand, shooting 60% on 9 out of 15 shooting. Fullerton has outscored UNLV 8-3 in the last 2 minutes. And the Titans, under coach John Sneed, enjoy a 22-14 lead.
Las Vegas right back with their man-for-man pressure.
Williams. Sabalas. Williams open for three. Scores it. A three-pointer by Wayne Williams. 25-14. A shot by Anderson Hunt doesn't drop for UNLV. Chased down by Young, and Young stepped over the line. Ray Young stepped over the baseline, out of bounds to the Titans. Who would have thought that Fullerton would have an 11-point lead with 13 minutes to play in the first half?
Well, they could put two back-to-back victories here that would really be something against Santa Barbara and then against Las Vegas.
And referee Terry Tackett has a foul against UNLV underneath the basket.
It's a hard decision Jerry Tarkanian has to make. His bread and butter is his man-for-man defense, but they're about a half step behind, but you hate to go to zone when you're trailing by 11 points.
The foul against Barry Young. Four team fouls against the Rebels. First one on Young. 25-14, the Titans of Cal State Fullerton. Along the baseline, Sabalos again! Cedric Sabalos, 27-14. Sabalos has 11 first half points.
Well, once Stacey Ogman picked up the fouls, they don't have, Vegas doesn't have anyone that can handle him defensively.
And Young with an air ball. Flip back into play by Sionovich over to Butler, and he's bumped hard by Moody. The foul on David Moody.
Again, their strategy is to foul Butler, to foul Akles, and put him at the free throw line.
Two fouls on David Moody.
Good positioning inside by Moody.
Nice save by Sionovich.
On a loose ball situation, Butler picks it up, and Moody is not going to give him a chance to get a field goal. Make him earn it at the line.
Tark will send in Jones into the UNLV lineup. Ackles comes out. So the Rebels will have Anderson Hunt, David Butler, who will be at the free throw line, Greg Anthony.
Now watch
Stacey Ogman and Jones.
Watch Butler's technique. He doesn't have good rotation on the ball. Jerry Tarkanian has several young players, Ackles and Butler in particular, that do not have good shooting technique. Now they may shoot a good percentage from the field because they get so many stickbacks on rebounds, but their lack of technique really shows at the free throw line.
Butler misses both free throws. David Butler is 1 out of 6 in the line here in the first half, and UNLV 4 out of 10 at the free throw line. Sabalos for 3, grabbed off by Stacey Ogman. A 13-point lead for Cal State Fullerton. 27-14, and I know that John Snead is saying to himself, we need all of the points we can get before this one is over. Stacey Ogman, Hunt, inside Butler. Ogman open from the corner. A three-pointer by Stacey Ogman, 27-17. Ogman has developed into a good three-point shooter.
Absolutely, shooting 46%.
And you know, last year he took only 2 three-pointers, made both. But you know, last year he was a freshman.
I hear he goes in the gym and shoots 1,000 shots a day.
1,000
shots a day. That's a lot.
It's got to take you over an hour to do that, I would think. 27-17, Cal State Fullerton. And then practice after that. Inside to Butler, out to Hunt.
A coach in this league told me they heard that he was shooting 1,000 a day. Look, ooh, again, their strategy, foul him, put him at the line.
Moody gets Butler, and Butler goes to the line. 1 out of 6 at the stripe so far.
Good pass inside to Butler. They simply are not going to let them have a layup.
And UNLV as a team, the Rebels are 4 out of 10 at the free throw line. Butler 1 out of 6. And David Butler has 2 shots coming. That one was in.
The only problem with that strategy of fouling when they're inside is that you eventually could lose Moody and you could eventually lose Sykes by doing that.
David Butler fouls the Fullerton strategy and cans both free throws. 27-19 the score. It was 27-14, but now 5 unanswered points. By UNLV, and UNLV putting some pressure on the Titans. They're going to have to hurry. Williams gets it across the 10-second timeline.
Moses Scurry came in for Butler. In the Fresno State game early in the year, Scurry came off the bench to save that ball game for Las Vegas.
Hill with a looping one-hander and slapped out of bounds, touched last by Fullerton, out of bounds UNLV. 27-19, Cal State Fullerton leading UNLV. We're not even at the midway point yet in the first half. 10:45 remaining.
Man from zone defense.
Hunt outside, puts it in. A three-pointer by Anderson Hunt, 27-22. And all of a sudden, it's been a good run by UNLV. 8 straight points.
Las Vegas is not an outstanding outside shooting team, but one thing that Jerry Tarkanian has done ahead of a lot of coaches in this country, he's made the three-point play an integral part of his offense.
Rashawn Lewis in the Fullerton lineup now to go along with Williams and Hill and Sabalos and Moody. And loose ball, Williams picks it up. And off the hands of Lewis, and they have called a foul against UNLV's James Jones.
Good defensive pressure. That was the first time that Fullerton looked a little bit apprehensive.
First foul on James Jones, 5th team foul, UNLV.
Defensive pressure on Williams, and he pushed him in the back. A good angle, good camera angle.
It was a 13-point lead for Cal State Fullerton. It's now a 5-point Fullerton lead. 27-22. Hill. There's the alley-oop to Sabalos, and Hill almost made a basket.
You never want to throw that over the rim. You throw it at the edge of the backboard. Watch Hill's pass. You never want it right over the rim. He can't handle that. You want it over the edge of the backboard. Just on the edge of the backboard and let him carry it right in.
You know, it's been very cold the last 3 or 4 days here in Southern California, but the humidity in this gym, it's almost balmy, summer-like. I mean, it's warm.
No, it's sticky in here. It is.
I'll say it is. You can tell by the officials. Look at their faces, how they're perspiring. Derrick Jones back in. Rashawn Lewis leaves for Fullerton as Stacy Ogman goes to the free throw line. The Rebels still have their problems at the line.
Stacy let the ball drop out of his fingertips and down on his heel.
Fullerton 27 and UNLV 22. Mark Hill. Over to Jones. Jones on the drive, and Terry Tackett has got the foul underneath against UNLV. It's against Jones.
Derrick Jones squared up very well. Took the ball down, a good step through.
And George Ackles will return to the UNLV lineup.
Jared Tarkanian doing a lot of substituting, trying to come up with some kind of rhythm in his team.
Ackles goes in for Jones. 27-22, Cal State Fullerton. Here's a steal, and it'll be Anthony with the left-handed jam. 27-24. Fullerton has been stuck on 27. The Titans led 27-14, and now it's been 10 straight UNLV points. The Rebels within 3. Out of bounds, UNLV. But off the hands of Sabalos.
They picked up the tempo. Their pressure defense, they've upped it a notch.
Remember that comment I said about John Snead? Said, yeah, you can't have too many points against this club. I made that when it was 27-14. Snead knows full well the explosiveness of this UNLV team. Hunt passing down underneath. There's the jam. Moses Scurry with the one-hander. 27-26. And John Sykes will come back in for Fullerton.
Just what Anderson Hunt. Good penetration. Fakes his jump shot. Beautiful pass to Moses Scurry.
And Moody pushed him. And Scurry still made it. So that's 3 fouls now on Moody.
Watch the strength of Scurry. And he's really excited. He's into the game.
Moses Scurry has his problems at the free throw line as well, 47%. Another miss by UNLV. Ackles doesn't get it. Loose ball, Scurry underneath. A gift for Moses Scurry, and UNLV takes the lead for the first time tonight at 28-27.
What is that, 12 or 14 straight points?
That is 12 straight points. 14 straight points, you're right. Hill with an air ball. Quickly, UNLV down court. Off to Scurry. Scurry loses the ball. Jones made the steal.
You know, the scary thing about this from the standpoint of other Big West teams is this is a very young Las Vegas team. Not very many seniors.
Sykes. Sabalos loses the ball.
He needs to get something going.
No basket, says Rich Ballesteros. Rich is going to take the basket away because of player control foul. Sabalos using the left hand.
Yes, as he penetrated, he pushed off with his left hand.
Two fouls on Sabalos. It's a one-point lead for UNLV at 28-27. Fullerton, after leading 27-14, has gone stone cold. The Rebels have moved it up a notch. They have scored 14 unanswered points. Sykes with the rebound off of that missed shot from Anthony. Wayne Williams.
Very important possession. Fullerton really needs to break the ice here.
8 minutes left in the first half. Williams shot off to the right. Williams off to Jones, and his shot good. 29-28, Fullerton. Down to Hunt. UNLV gets that ball down court so quickly.
They're a great transition team.
29-28, Fullerton. Hunt gets around his man Williams and scores it. Anderson Hunt. 30-29, UNLV.
Fullerton's playing a matchup zone, but you can't allow those guards to penetrate. That's the thing that's really hurting them. They're penetrating and drawing the defense and then dropping it off to their big people. Awfully close to travel by Cedric.
Sabalos' shot is good. Sabalos now with 13 first half points. 31-30, Fullerton leading UNLV.
He is a great open court player.
Remember, in the first meeting, Sabalos had 31 points and 13 rebounds. An air ball by Stacey Augman. Here comes Sabalos. Sabalos doing it all. All the way, pulls up the five-footer. No. Sabalos can't find the handle, and it goes over the baseline. Out of bounds, UNLV.
He didn't watch the ball in his hand. He was trying to grab it and shoot it at the same time.
David Butler re-enters the UNLV lineup, but first we'll get a timeout. With 7 minutes left here in the first half, it's a one-point advantage, Cal State Fullerton over UNLV.
Want to find out the scores of the day, the fast-breaking sports news, and the people who make it? Then you want Prime Ticket Daily News Dial Sports. It's the fastest, easiest way to find out game analysis, weather information, player injuries, and with up-to-the-minute reporting 24 hours a day with fresh updates every 5 minutes. Plus, find out what's on Prime Ticket tonight. Just call 213-976-1313. Prime Ticket Daily News Dial Sports.
You don't have to buy a sports car to get a 5-speed transmission, power steering, AM-FM stereo cassette, fuel-injected engine, anti-lock rear brakes, 6-year, 60,000-mile powertrain warranty. How do you get all this for under $10,000? Simple. You buy this newly designed Ford Ranger XLT with all these sports car features, plus a really big trunk.
Get 4.9% financing or up to $750 cash bonus on 89 Rangers.
Tomorrow, Prime Ticket delivers exciting women's basketball as the UCLA Bruins host the Trojans of USC. The action starts at 9 o'clock right here on Prime Ticket, sports television at its best. For Cal State Fullerton, as you look at John Sneed, the 40-year-old head coach in his first year here at Cal State Fullerton, it's Jones, Sykes, Hill, Sabalos, and Williams. 1 point lead for the Titans. 6:50 to go, first half.
Fullerton State lost a lot of very good basketball players from last year's team, but they brought in two very exciting junior college players in Sabalos and in Mark Hill.
The basket underneath by Butler. 32-31, UNLV. Mark Hill. Butler's got 11 for UNLV despite his free throw shooting woes. Jones, 10-footer, yes, Derrick Jones. So they're trading baskets now. Fullerton back into a one-point lead. 8 points for Jones.
Well, Jones along with Sabalos, both of them are good one-on-one players, and Moses Curry just simply didn't have good defensive position.
Augman's 10-footer along the baseline. Grabbed off by Sykes. And Sykes rolls it off the right foot of David Butler. Smart play because Sykes was falling out of bounds. George Ackles in for UNLV, replacing Moses Scurry.
Well, Moses gave him a lift when he came in, but his defensive position was bad. He's either tired or poor defensive position, and here comes George Ackles.
In the backcourt to Williams, 33-32, Cal State Fullerton. Mark Hill, tough angle shot. Fullerton not getting many second shots. Down to Hunt. Hunt to Butler, and Butler is fouled.
Well, John Sykes had a foul to give, and so he did. Reached in, didn't want Butler shooting a layup.
Now, the last time Butler was at the free throw line, David made two in a row.
Great lead pass. Anderson Hunt, again, a very good pass. Sykes grabs it. Grabs him, does not allow him to shoot it. Let's take a look again. Sykes just reaches over and doesn't give him any chance to make the basket.
Clint Rossum back in for UNLV. So the Rebels will have Butler at the free throw line. Clint Rossum, Greg Anthony, George Ackles, and Stacy Ogman.
Watch the rotation on this ball. He doesn't have backspin. A good flip on the ball has backspin.
And look at Tark. He says, I can't look anymore.
Yeah, those free throws would drive you nuts.
33 out of 32. That one was way short. And a foul against George Ackles. I think reaching over the top.
Well, it's back to what I talked about before, Mike. You want to pronate, a kind of a pronating move as opposed to supination. Let's watch his free throw. He put side spin on the ball. It's like a knuckleball going up.
And your definition of pronation is?
Well, that you flip the ball and you extend to put backspin on the ball. You flip it off your index finger and your middle finger and your thumb.
Rashawn Lewis, a 50% free throw shooter. He hasn't been at the line much this season. Doesn't get this one. Rossum is quickly over there to grab it off for UNLV. 33-32, Fullerton leading the Rebels. The running Rebels of UNLV. Butler back out in front to Anthony, traveling on Anthony. And Anthony looks over in the direction of Jerry Tarkanian. He says, I really don't think I did it, coach.
Well, it was a good move. They went inside to Butler and caused the zone to collapse, and he kicked it right back out, and as the zone spread, he penetrated. Very nice job, except he may have picked up his pivot thing.
Randall Moose in there for Fullerton. Moose on the left wing, and now Sabalos throws it away. He was trying to hit Sykes with the pass and threw it in front of him.
Well, he was going one direction and threw across his body. You try never to pass the ball across your body.
Ogman, Anthony, inside Butler. And Butler is fouled by either Moose or Sykes, and it was Sykes who got him in from behind.
They're penetrating very well into the zone. They find David Butler. He squares up nicely. And they're reaching in and hacking him, and they're not having to pay for it. So they're, you know, David Butler, if he doesn't want to be butchered in there, is going to have to start hitting the free throws. Now let's watch the rotation again.
Marlon Vaughn into the lineup for Cal State Fullerton. He replaces Sabalos.
If we can pick up the rotation on the ball, he should have backspin.
You believe that UNLV only 6 out of 17 at the free throw line, and yet the Rebels trail by just a point. A shot by Randall Moose. Rebound David Butler, and again Fullerton getting just one shot.
Well, again, that is Vegas's strength, the rebounding.
Anthony, air ball, grabbed off by Sykes. 33-32, Fullerton. 4:20 left in the first half, and Vaughn throws it away.
Jerry Tarkanian very upset with Greg Anthony's choice of shots.
In mid-January, Jan 16th, when UNLV won in Vegas over this Fullerton team, 66-63, the Titans made 27 turnovers, 20 in the first half.
And yet, only lost by 3 points.
And it took a buzzer beater, a 23-footer by Anthony that banked in to beat him. Sionovich, Ogman, Rossum, Ackles. George Ackles pours it in.
George Ackles is improving as an offensive player. He was just a shot blocker and defender at the beginning of the year, but he's making some progress.
7 points in the first half for Ackles, and it's a 1-point lead, UNLV. little over 3.5 minutes left here in the first period. Mike Walden and Ted Owens. Van Anderson drives. Fingertip roll. Doesn't get it. And the officials have called a foul against Fullerton.
Unless I missed something, I think he double dribbled.
The foul was on Anderson, a player control foul on Van Anderson. Rashawn Lewis leaves. Derrick Jones returns for Fullerton. So the Rebels, 6 out of 17 at the free throw line. And Rossum says something to Cianovic. Rossum's a good free throw shooter. He's 77%. So I know that Jerry Tarkanian is happy to see Clint Rossum take the 1-1.
Yeah, of his starters, he's the very best. Now look at the beautiful rotation on the ball. Again, he's shooting it, letting it leave. The last thing it hits that ball is his index finger.
First point of the game for Rossum. It's 37-34, UNLV by three. 3:37 left in the first half.
Sorry, Alex, you know the rules, buddy.
Let me have a stereo's, Pat. About my monthly tab, seems really high.
No, that's right.
Looks high to me.
Maybe you shouldn't let your buddy use it.
My buddy?
Brown hair, wears it long.
Is he short?
Yeah, talks funny, too.
Woof.
Says that a lot.
Stroh's, fire brewed for smooth, consistent taste.
Eats the peanuts right out of the bowl, too.
You hear the thunder, thunder.
If you've been itching for the hot looks, high performance, and driving excitement of a Pontiac Grand Am, now's the time to act.
Get on your Pontiac and ride! Pontiac ride!
Because now, with up to $1,100 cash back for qualified first-time buyers, the hot-handling Pontiac Grand Am fits your budget like never before.
Rebuild excitement!
What can you expect when you invest at Schwab? Ask a Schwab customer.
I'm looking for quick response and accuracy. I call Schwab and often get my market orders confirmed while I'm still on the phone. I like the fact that there's no sales pressure. For me, Schwab simply delivers good service, good value.
For a free booklet, call 800-445-4800. That's 800-445-4800.
You're looking at the running Rebel huddle. They whip UC Santa Barbara 77-61 Monday night over at the Thomas and Mack Center. And that snapped UNLV out of a two-game losing streak. They had lost to Oklahoma and to UC Irvine. 15-5 overall, 19th in the nation, UNLV. And the Rebels now leading 36-33, 3.5 minutes to go. This is first half action from Titan Gym.
They've gone to their trap, their 1-3-1 trap.
And it's a steal by Clint Rossum. The Titans look disorganized right now.
They changed their defensive strategy. They went to a trap then instead of their man for man.
Butler off to Stacey Ogman. Cianovic was open, but he's not going to take the shot.
Fullerton staying with their matchup zone.
36-33. Cianovic to Butler. Rossum. Rebound Ogman. Lays it in nicely. 38-33, and Sykes, I think, got poked in the eye, and Richie Ballesteros, one of the officials, immediately saw it. Officials timeout. They get a towel out. Sykes claims he can't see out of his right eye.
Well, it was a great rebound by Stacey Ogman, and with one step, look at the distance that Stacey Ogman covers. He established a pivot foot when he rebounded.
Might have taken an extra
he
step.
He might have. He very well could have.
38-33 the score.
That's why he picked up so much ground.
Wayne Williams for Cal State Fullerton. 5-point lead, UNLV. Mark Hill, try to trap him. With Zabalos. Brent Calvin scores it. Brent Calvin for Cal State Fullerton. 38-35, UNLV. That's a bonus when they can get some scoring from Calvin.
Well, he's averaging 1.6, and that exceeded it with the one shot.
38-35. We're down to the final 2 minutes of this game. in the first half. Cianovic, Augman. Cianovic will take the shot. Rebound Calvin, out to Williams, a three on one, off to Hill. Hill over Cianovic, doesn't get it to funnel through, a tip in by Jones. Derrick Jones, 1 point lead UNLV of 38-37.
Well, that was great reaction by Derrick Jones because Mark Hill had held on to the ball in their 1-3, I mean their 3-on-1 break too long.
There's Ackles on the five-footer. The basket will count and a foul on Brent Calvin.
Las Vegas doing a very good job in the zone, finding the man coming in the middle. Ackles came in late, just turned over and squared, flipped it in. Nice play by Ackles.
And Ray Young will come back in for UNLV. Going out, Stacy Augman. John Sneed has three guys he likes to use in the middle. John Sykes, David Moody, and Brent Calvin. He says, those three guys, I hope, get me 10 points and 10 rebounds a game. That's what I'm trying to get out of those three.
Well, and it's really important in this ball game that he plays all three of them because his strategy is to foul Butler and foul Ackles every time they get the ball inside. Put him at the free throw line.
Ackles just made the free throw, and it's 41-37 UNLV. In case you're just joining us on the telecast, Fullerton had a 27-14 lead, and then 14 straight points by UNLV, and the Rebels have been in command. Traveling on Jones. No basket by Derrick Jones. UNLV 41, Cal State Fullerton 37.
Derrick Jones did a great job of splitting the zone, went inside the zone, but he did pick up his pivot foot.
There's Butler all alone, nobody around him. That was easy. 43-37 UNLV.
They're starting Butler in the middle, sliding him down, and then bringing Ackles right in behind him.
13 points for David Butler, first half action. Williams, Sabalos. Sabalos lays it off to Jones. Jones scores it. Derrick Jones, 43-39, the final 40 seconds of the first half.
Jared Tarkanian wants the last shot of the half.
Jones has 12. Sabalos the leader for Fullerton here in the first half, the scoring leader.
29 seconds to go. Fullerton's in their 2-3 zone. Vegas is going to hold it. I suspect that they'll start maybe with some sort of an attack against the zone right now. You don't want to wait too long. You'll end up taking a bad shot. Too spread out now. They should be going at it aggressively. Takes longer to attack the zone. Travel.
Traveling on Butler. 4 seconds left, so maybe Fullerton will get the last shot now. It's a 4-point UNLV lead, 43-39. Here comes Williams. Williams lets her fly way wide to the left. You know, against Santa Barbara here the other night, Williams made one from 35 feet to beat the buzzer at the end of the first half. So this time, halftime score, UNLV 43, Fullerton 39.
The challenge, to sell an unbelievable 300 new and used cars in February. Right now, Harbor Hyundai, South Coast Dodge Isuzu Peugeot in Costa Mesa will do anything to meet the challenge. We've got over 500 new Hyundai, Dodge Isuzu Peugeots, all priced to move. The challenge, drive home any new 1988 for $88 below invoice. Hyundai, Dodge, Isuzu, $88 below invoice.
That's with no money down.
Hurry to Harbor Hyundai, South Coast Dodge Isuzu Peugeot in Costa Mesa.
Cruiser War 89. Six fantastic cruiserweight matchups. NABF champ Smokin' Bert Cooper defends his title against Nate Mr. Miller. And battling for top ranking, see two-time world champ Dwight Muhammad Kawe, the superstar of Africa, Nigerian national champ Bashiro Ali, courageous Craig Bojanowski. It's a pay-per-view event. February 15th, Cruiser War 89.
The 1989 Buick Regal. It brings a new kind of style to the American road.
It's a regal new feeling, a style that's appealing. The look of a Buick today.
The great American road was made for Regal.
It's a regal new style, the pride in a smile. It's the road that Regal commands.
Oh, the great American road belongs to Buick.
If some sports leave you cold this weekend, warm up with ABC Sports. Saturday, America's new Queen of the Ice will be crowned as ABC's Wide World of Sports presents the U.S. Figure Skating Championships. On Sunday, Subaru presents the World Alpine Skate Championships. And on ABC's College Basketball, Louisville takes on UCLA, or Purdue meets Indiana. Then live coverage of the men's competition as the U.S. Figure Skating Championships conclude. It's red-hot excitement all weekend on ABC Sports.
Hi, I'm General Chuck Yeager. If you're a high school senior or college student and considering joining the armed forces after graduation, check out the Air National Guard. The Air Guard will teach you a skill, help pay for your college education, and you'll earn good pay and benefits. And best of all, you'll serve right here at home. If you've got what it takes and want to be a part of America's team, call your Air Guard recruiter today at 714-655-4791 or 818-909-2330.
A great first half, and UNLV leading Cal State Fullerton 43-39 here at the intermission at Titan Gym on the Cal State Fullerton campus in Fullerton, California. Hello again, everybody. This is Mike Walden along with Ted Owens. The series stands, the 22 times that UNLV and Fullerton played one another. UNLV has won 20 times, Fullerton only two. The Titans have not beaten UNLV in 6 years. They had a good first half lead, 27-14, but then the Rebels took over and the Rebels are now in command.
Well, you know, the thing that's a little bit scary about the Rebels is that they're doing so many things wrong. They've taken bad shots, they're shooting poorly at the free throw line, and yet they're 4 points ahead. It's their offensive rebounding, it's their depth and so forth. They are a very potentially powerful team.
You look at this series, and so many times Fullerton has had a great first half or sent it into overtime, but they have lost in the overtime or lost at the buzzer. They just can't seem to get over the hump. And even when it was 27-14, I'm sure John Steed was thinking, hey, I'm glad we're ahead by 13, but we got to get more points than that. We can't rest on that lead, and that proved to be very true.
Well, you read that perfectly and made the comment they need more points right now, because against a team like Vegas that has so many ways they can hurt you, rebounding, even though they're not a great outside shooting team, all of a sudden they get their rhythm, they hit a couple of three-pointers outside, but it's their terrific athletic ability that makes the difference.
And I think that's the one reason that UNLV has been so successful in this league. The Big West, or the previous 6 years, the old PCAA conference, teams play them close, but then UNLV knows what it takes to win. Now, I'm not saying that UNLV is going to go ahead and win this game, but they are ahead by four at the half, and they do seem to be able to make up ground so quickly.
Well, and it's not altogether that they have so many great individuals. They just have so many good players. If you look in the last 10 years, they haven't had that many guys that make the NBA rosters, but they have a lot of great players. You won't ever see them that they don't have 9 or 10 good players.
And Tark is deep this year, and that depth really helped him in the first half. Halftime score, UNLV 43, Cal State Fullerton 39.
The multiple-port fuel-injected Ford Escort GT. Because what's rock without roll?
Get 4.9% financing or $500 cash bonus on 89 Escort.
Attention fans, the Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers proudly announce the On the Road with the Kings contest. You could win a new Mitsubishi Mighty Max 4x4 truck, courtesy of your Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers. You'll also join the Los Angeles Kings on a road trip when they battle the New Jersey Devils and New York Rangers in late February. You'll fly round trip to New York, courtesy of today's TWA. Find out how good they are to New York and stay at the beautiful Sheraton Center provided by Sheraton, the hospitality people of ITT. To enter, fill out the entry form available at your participating Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers, or send your name, address, and phone number on a postcard to On the Road with the Kings, 401 South Prairie, Suite 104, Inglewood, California, 90301. Entries must be received by February 15th.
Nichols to Duchesne, he scores!
Don't get shut out. Break away to your participating Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers and enter today.
It's hard to believe that this was a desert less than 30 years ago. Hello, I'm Bob Maxson, and now we're on our way to becoming one of the best urban universities in the country, and that's our goal. We're dedicated to serving the educational needs of the citizens of Nevada and the great Southwest. We have an unwavering commitment to academic excellence for the sake of these young people and future generations of Nevadans. We live in a dynamic city of over 500,000 people who are helping us build.
You struggle to keep going, trying to escape it. But if you think there's no way out, you're living in a private nightmare of your own creation. That's what happens when you put off doing your taxes to the last minute. Wake up and do something about it. File now, file accurately, and make your taxes less taxing.
Accommodations arranged through Hilton and the Hilton Honors Program, which offers frequent travelers the fastest route to a free hotel stay. Call 1-800-HILTONS for details.
We're getting ready to start play in the second half with UNLV up by 4 over Cal State Fullerton. And the Rebels' number one scorer coming into this one, Stacy Augman, got into foul trouble. He got two personal fouls in the first 45 seconds. Jerry Tarkanian took him out and settled him down. And then Augman was able to come back and help in the last 5 minutes of the first half.
Well, it was good that he came back and played aggressively, even though he had that many fouls. He made a big basket on a rebounded shot. Good long stride. He was able to get it in. Great rebound.
6 first half points for Augman. David Butler the leader, despite his troubles at the free throw line. 13 for Butler. Ackles, 10 points. And Ackles, who was fouled out of 9 games, had just one personal foul in the first half. And you can see the rest of the scoring for UNLV. Cedric Sabala started out this game like it was a one-man mission for the 6'7 junior. He was scoring all over the place.
Well, he's a great open court player. Great rebound. This is one of the things he does very well, but he plays so well in the open court.
Cedric Sabalos with 13 points, followed by Derek Jones with 12. Mark Hill had a couple of three-pointers, a total of 10. But then the scoring really falls off for Cal State Fullerton.
Well, and I think that's the difference in the two ball clubs, probably the depth factor.
Let's take a look at the team statistics in the first half. It's 43-39, UNLV leading. Both teams shooting 50% or better. Look at the free throws. 9 out of 21 for UNLV. 42%. That's hard to believe.
Well, the two statistics that are really important as far as UNLV is concerned is that they were able to get 3 more rebounds and had 3 less turnovers. So that's 6 possessions of the ball, and that's about the difference in the score.
Right now it's 43-39, UNLV. The second half coming right up.
Cruiser War 89. 6 fantastic cruiserweight matchups. NABF champ Smokin' Bert Cooper defends his title against Nate Mr. Miller. And battling for top ranking seed, 2-time world champ Wright Muhammad Kawe. The superstar of Africa, Nigerian national champ Bashiro Ali. Courageous Craig Bojanowski. It's a pay-per-view event. February 15th, Cruiser War 89.
Crosstown rivals USC and UCLA get set to put on a show at Poly Pavilion as Prime Tickets showcases the women's game tomorrow night. It's all drama on the Poly Hardcourt as the women of Troy meet the Bruins tomorrow night.
Shores, but these mighty rocks stand fast, big and strong. Well, that's the kind of strength folks have been counting on for over 100 years with Great Western. You see, Great Western is built on a solid base of over $32 billion in assets and backed by the security of federal insurance. So if you want a bank that'll make your money grow safely, come to Great Western Bank.
we'll be standing big and strong, no matter how the tides change.
BlackRock, Nevada, and old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. BlackRock means land sailing, riding the wind across dry desert lakes. And old Milwaukee means a great beer, cold, crisp old Milwaukee beer, and smooth, golden old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place, an old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and old Milwaukee light.
You know, guys, it doesn't get any better than this.
Well, I know that Jerry Pym, the head coach at UNLV, at UC Santa Barbara, is watching this game up in Santa Barbara tonight. Jerry Pym and the Gauchos have the night off. They will be in action at 5 o'clock Saturday afternoon. We'll have it for you on the Prime Ticket Network. Santa Barbara versus San Jose State. I'm kind of anxious to get up there and see what kind of a club that Bill Berry's putting on the floor these days.
Yeah, that'll be interesting. He's put together some football players, some track stars. And they haven't been that effective as far as winning, but they've been up really in a lot of ball games.
Although the Spartans have lost 9 in a row. Fullerton has lost 15 in a row to UNLV, down by 4. Sabalos drops it off to Jones, his shot, yes!
Sabalos.
Derek Jones, 43-41.
Beautiful job by Cedric Sabalos. So penetrated, drew the defense, dropped it off to Derek Jones.
Jones is 7 out of 8 from the floor and shooting in the game. Here's Sabalos. He's got it. High game, 43 all.
That's the way you want to start a second half.
Rebels up by 4 at the half, now tied at 43. Butler can't get it, and it is touched last by David Butler. It'll be out of bounds to Cal State Fullerton. First 45 seconds of the second half, and the Titans have caught UNLV at 43.
Well, they came out playing. They say the two most important periods in the game, the first 5 minutes of the ball game, the first 5 minutes of the second half, and that's certainly been true here for Fullerton.
Fullerton won the first 5 minutes of the game and on the verge of winning this second half. There is Williams' follow-up. Sabalos doesn't get it, and it's kicked back out to Mark Hill.
Oh, he was open at point-blank range and missed it.
Sometimes you press a little too hard. Sabalos on a 12-footer. Grabbed off by Clint Rossum. Bumped a little bit by Sykes, but no harm and no foul. Incidental contact.
Sabalos really creates shots. He can get open in a one-on-one situation.
Sabalos has 15 points to lead both teams in scoring. Butler puts up the shot. Looked like a shot put. Rebounded by Sykes of Fullerton. 43 all. We've played 2 minutes of the second half. Capacity crowd here. Sell out of 4,000. That's all they can get into this little gym on the Cal State Fullerton campus.
Well, people automatically think that Las Vegas has beautiful technique. They do all things well. But their young players simply do not have good shooting technique, and they have a lot of work ahead.
Rossum off to Augman. Augman scores. 45-43, UNLV back into the lead.
Pressure again down court, man for man.
Mark Hill.
They want Sabalos in that one-on-one situation as much as they can.
Hill takes an off-balance shot, fouled by Rossum, who pleads his case to Brent Smith, who made the call. It's been a tough week so far for UNLV. They had a rough ride getting back after that one-point loss to Irvine Sunday morning. They lost Saturday night, and the Sunday morning flight back to UNLV, very bumpy. Then they had to play Santa Barbara, beat Santa Barbara Monday night, 77-61. They're here at Fullerton tonight. They leave tomorrow, and they will play North Carolina State at NC State Sunday afternoon.
They have a 6 o'clock flight in the morning.
Hill at the line. And Hill is 3 out of 3 at the free throw line, and the game is tied at 45.
The flight was so rough that all the Vegas players thought they were going to die, and Jerry said he didn't know anything was happening, that he had too much to worry about.
The follow-up by Augman, 47-45. Augman with 8 points. Down to Sabalos, 5-footer, no, but he's fouled.
Let's see who fouled. They'll be in real.
It is David Butler.
David came over to support because Ogman's afraid to get in foul trouble, and he reached in and fouled him. Good follow-up by Derrick Jones.
Sabalos will be at the free throw line. Sabalos, one out of two at the line. He's got 15 points in the game. Cedric Sabalos. When he came out here tonight to the gym, he had his right wrist taped up heavily, and you know what he had around his left wrist? A snake. A baby boa constrictor. I kid you not. He had a snake around his left wrist. But he started out like a house of fire. I guess a lot of guys would be having a snake around the wrist if they can play as well in the first 5 minutes of a half as Sabalos did. A couple of free throws by Cedric ties the game at 47. 17 points for Cedric Sabalos. I guess his snake is back in the locker room. I'm not sure. I hope he's back there. And Terry Tackett has the foul on Wayne Williams.
They say it's a young boa constrictor.
Well, whether it's young, old, or middle-aged, I don't want any part of it.
Again, penetration to Ackles. And they reached in and fouled Ackles, but it's not a shooting foul.
Second foul against Williams. Second team foul on Fullerton. And we'll see what the call is here. It's off the knee of Sabalos, so it'll be out of bounds, UNLV. Game is tied at 47. John Sneed going up against Jerry Tarkanian.
Fullerton.
Underneath, there is Ogman. Fullerton fast asleep. Ogman, 49-47.
That's exactly the hole that Ackles found in that zone after a out-of-bounds situation last time.
12 points now for Stacey Ogman. Bounce
good
pass to Jones.
Back.
There he Jones misses the jam. Ogman with it. Feeds over his shoulder to Anthony. Anthony back over to Butler, and the ball is knocked away. And Butler will go to the free throw line. Talk about your wild and woolly action.
A great athletic play by Stacey Ogman. Saw the open man. Rossum came down, laid it back. Butler coming in. They reached in and fouled him again. That's their strategy.
How did Jones miss that one-handed jam?
Oh, I don't know. You're a big leaper. You're 6'7", 6'8". He must have just taken his eye off the rim.
You coached 19 years at Kansas, and one of your guys missed a jam. What did you do?
He's on the bench.
Now, huh?
Yes.
49-47. Would you say anything to him when he would
no.
come off?
No, he ran off. He knew exactly what had happened.
50-47, UNLV. Butler goes to the line again as Jones is in. Ackles will go out. And now John Sneed will send in David Moody, replacing John Sykes. Moody fouled up a lot of fouls in the first half. He had 4 first half fouls, so he may not be with us long tonight. David Moody. Butler misses again at the line, and Jones with it for Fullerton. A 3-point lead for UNLV.
I think we're going to see a lot of John Sykes and Brent Calvin, because Moody could go out of this game anytime.
Mark Hill for 3. He's got it. 3 three-pointers in the game for Mark Hill. Game tied at 50. We've played 4 minutes of the second half. Rossum lays it off nicely to Butler, and it's rejected by Jones. The foul on Derrick Jones.
Well, if he'd have kept his hand straight up, I think he would have been all right, but he hit down on the foul.
Third foul on Jones.
Let's watch Jones now. Rossum penetrates, kicks the ball off, and Jones hit down. If he hadn't hit down and kept his hand straight up, he would have been okay.
Butler at the line tonight had his problems in the first half. He's 4 out of 12 at the free throw line. David Butler. In the first half, UNLV was only 42% at the free throw line. That one rattles home.
Well, Butler again, if you watch the rotation, you want to finish with your thumb down and that index finger. Last thing it hits it.
He rattles both of them home. A couple of free throws by David Butler, who has had 13 chances at the free throw line tonight, and he has converted 6. It's a 2-point lead, UNLV.
Logan Pass, Montana, and Old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. Logan Pass means trailblazing, exploring the wilderness of Glacier National Park. And Old Milwaukee means a great beer. Cold, crisp Old Milwaukee beer and smooth, golden Old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place and Old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee light.
Guys, it just doesn't get any better than this. We're giving away $1,000 on Monday, $1,000 on Tuesday, and every day of the week. During your Southern California Chevrolet Dealer Association's $1,000 a day, every day test drive giveaway. Now, there's no obligation, nothing to buy, and there's a new winner every day. So come on in and test drive any new Chevrolet or Geo import, and then enter the $1,000 a day, every day test drive giveaway. Only at your Southern California Chevrolet dealers.
Tonight's Big West Conference game is brought to you by your participating Southern California Chevrolet dealers, home of the $1,000 a day, everyday test drive giveaway. No obligation, nothing to buy. Just test drive any new Chevrolet or GEO import. And by Stroh's and Stroh's Light. Now you're talking good times, and Stroh's is spoken here. How many times have you seen that shot? The arms stretched back. You couldn't tell if Tark was ahead or behind.
No, but deep down, you know how he feels.
Of
that guy loves the game of basketball. He's really into it.
516 victories. Oh, 5 second count. Jones couldn't inbound the ball in the allotted 5 seconds.
You know, the thing that I didn't know until I looked at the record books, Jerry Tarkanian was an extremely successful junior college coach. He won 5 state California championships in junior college.
Absolutely. Pasadena City College. There is a shot by Rossum. Grabbed off around by Sabalos for the Titans. 52-50. UNLV leading Cal State Fullerton. Sabalos sees some daylight. Kicks it off over to Hill. Hill for 3. Air ball. Butler to Anthony. 2-point UNLV lead.
The thing that's so good about Sabalos, he goes to his left equally as well as he goes to his right.
Anthony. Rossum lays it up nice and easy. Clint Rossum, 54-50 UNLV. Rossum has 4 points.
Critical time in this ball game, and John Snead wants a timeout to talk it over.
Well, they couldn't inbound the ball, and now they throw it away. So the last two possessions, Fullerton coming up empty. 54-50, UNLV leading Cal State Fullerton.
Your Southern California Chevrolet Dealers Association announces the $1,000 a day, every day test drive giveaway. Now there's a $1,000 winner every day of the week. That's right, every day of the week. There's no obligation, nothing to buy. And there's a new winner every day. So come on in and test drive any new Chevrolet or Geo import, and then enter the $1,000 a day, every day test drive giveaway. Only at your Southern California Chevrolet dealers.
Oh, look at this. It's priceless.
Naturally.
It's Mom and Dad's 50th wedding anniversary.
Here we go.
Oh, wait, I'm going to charge it with the American Express card. That way it's automatically insured.
Hi, did you get it?
Hi, Mom.
Terrific.
You won't believe it.
Don't worry. Remember, I used the American Express card.
So it's insured.
Lost, stolen, or damaged. A way to protect the things you buy. Membership has its privileges.
You better think, babe. Think about it before you turn the key. Think, babe, before you sit in the driver's seat. Cause you use caution. You gotta use caution. You gotta use caution. Don't drink and drive, y'all. I'm out here. You know what I'm saying? Caution. You gotta use caution. You gotta use caution. Just drink and drive. Ain't gotta work, you know what I mean? Think, please.
Saturday, the Spartans of San Jose State will be up at the Campus Event Center on the UC Santa Barbara campus, and it'll be the Spartans of San Jose State versus UCSB. We'll have it for you live, 5 o'clock, right here on the Prime Ticket Sports Network. The best in collegiate sports on Prime Ticket. 5 o'clock Saturday, Santa Barbara, San Jose State. Get a chance to see Carrick DeHart for the Gauchos. along with Carlton Davenport, Mike Doyle, Wayne Daniels playing for San Jose State.
Well, they need to win, obviously, to get back into the race. UNLV has finally lost a game to Irvine.
Yeah, but Santa Barbara's dropped a couple now. 54-50. Underneath. Ogman doesn't. Yeah, it started to drop, and then Jones punched it out. That'll be interference. Basket will go to Stacy Ogman. 56-50 UNLV.
Ogman grabbed the rebound. He puts it up, and it's hanging in the net. Derek Jones reached in and knocked it out. This is the way they used to do it when they had peach baskets. They had a broom that stuck in and knocked it out.
6-point lead for UNLV. Jones has it rejected, and it's going to be goaltending against UNLV. The basket will go to Derek Jones. James Jones had his hand in the way and got it on the downward flight. 56-52. 16 tonight for Derek Jones of Cal State Fullerton. 4-point lead, UNLV. Anthony near the top of the free throw circle has it knocked away by Hill, and Anthony gets it right back for UNLV. Underneath, there is Ogman. Ogman puts it up, scores it. The basket counts. Ogman foul will go to the line.
Anytime you're playing a 2-3 zone, there's a seam right behind the front line, and they found it. They found Ogman right behind the defense. He made a great play. He took it right up through the arms and has a chance for 3 points.
Sabalos picking up his third personal. Sabalos has been the main offensive thrust for Cal State Fullerton. Ogman makes it 59-52. Biggest lead tonight for UNLV, 7 points.
Ogman's not going to take too many chances.
Oh, Sabalos was fouled and nothing was called. The ball was knocked away there by Ogman.
It barely grazed Ogman's leg. It's good thinking. Good thinking. He was under a lot of pressure in the double team.
59-52. UNLV by 7. And it comes to John Sykes. Actually, right now, Fullerton has only 3 scoring threats. Hill is 1. Rebounded by Ackles. The other 2, Sabalos and Jones. Little tough when you have only 3 guys to score and you're up against 5. 59-52 UNLV. Hunt inside. Butler right back over to Anderson. Hunt misses the 3-point attempt, saved by Sabalos to Wayne Williams. Williams at the free throw line, out to Hill. Hill rattles it home for 3. That is 4 3-point baskets tonight by Mark Hill. He's 4 out of 5 from 3-point range.
Well, credit Wayne Williams. He made great penetration into the heart of the defense and kicked it off, found Mark Hill along the sideline. Beautiful pass.
Hunt inside. Ackles back out to Anthony. He lets her fly.
That's their game right there. Second shot.
And sometimes a third and fourth shot. 59-55 UNLV. We've got 13 minutes left.
Greg Anthony's taken some marginal shots, but he fortunately has teammates who can jump well on the board. Watch Ogman and watch Butler.
And that foul is on Sabalos, number 4 on Sabalos. So he's got to come out of the game. 13 minutes left. John Snead has no other choice. Sabalos comes out replaced by Van Anderson, who just became eligible about 2 weeks ago. He's a transfer from Oregon State. He played last year for the Titans, then had academic difficulties and became eligible 2 weeks ago.
Mike, watch, see whether he finishes with his thumb up or his thumb down on his shot.
Whatever it was successful. A couple of free throws by Butler, 61-55. Butler is 7 out of 16 at the free throw line. 7 out of 16.
Well, as Jerry Tarkanian said, gee, how good we could be if we just hit those free throws.
Williams passing out to Jones. Williams fouled by Butler. 2 fouls on David Butler. One thing tonight, Butler and Ackles have not committed a lot of fouls.
Williams penetrated. Butler was in no position, just reached in and fouled. Very good call by the officials.
Moses Scurry back in for UNLV. Butler will go to the bench. Coming in, Ackles had fouled out 9 times, and Butler had fouled out 5 times, but they're not in any foul trouble at all right now. And it comes over to Mark Hill. 61-55.
Well, even though he was behind early, Jerry Tarkanian did a lot of substituting in the first half, and they're a fairly well-rested team.
Well, he's got a strong bench. No wonder he substitutes the way he has. He can rotate Young and Jones in there, along with Scurry and Ackles and Butler. So he's got the luxury of five guys that he can rotate.
Yeah, it makes a lot easier decision, doesn't it? Well, again, just a reaching foul. Hunt did not have position, had his arm into Mark Hill. Officials right on top of it.
First foul on Anderson Hunt. Mark Hill off to Van Anderson. Underneath there is Sykes, and he jams it home. The basket counts, and a foul called underneath against Moses Scurry.
John Sykes has a big body inside, a very good pass inside. Sykes just goes right up and takes it and sticks it. A big body, is hard to get around in there.
The only points that John Sykes has been able to score tonight, and you just saw it on the jam.
John Sykes comes in the game. All that John Snead expects of him is to get the rebound, get the stick backs.
Sykes is a 62% free throw shooter. Tim Gergerich, the assistant at UNLV, talking to Moses Scurry. So the Titans of Cal State Fullerton hanging in here in the second half, down by just three, 12 minutes, 14 seconds remaining.
Moses Scurry wasn't in the game but about 10 seconds that time.
It'll be over and back, out of bounds to Cal State Fullerton.
The ball went inside. There was good pressure. The hands were up, and he just overthrew the guards. But you have to go pick up the ball, or Wayne Williams scores on it.
It's been 6 years since Fullerton beat UNLV. The last time occurred the 24th February, Leon Wood's team, 1983. Sykes, misses underneath on a scoop shot, out of bounds UNLV. That could be a four-point turnaround right there.
You bet. It was a good play by John Sykes. He penetrates well, takes it to the hole. He's so much stronger. UNLV has tall players, but they're not very strong except in Moses Scurry.
They're tall and skinny.
Yes.
With bony elbows. 61-58, make it 63-58 on the basket by Stacy Augman.
Against the 2-3 zone, you'll find that short corner open, and that's where they're getting the ball now.
19 points by Augman. Williams drives underneath. Van Anderson is fouled.
Probably a good foul because he had a sure 2 points. Good penetration by Wayne Williams. Let's take a look at him as he penetrates. Kicks it off to Anderson. And it was a good foul. If you're going to foul, don't let him have any chance to hit the 2 points.
Foul is on Greg Anthony. His second, 16 fouls. And Rashawn Lewis back in for Cal State Fullerton, replacing Derek Jones.
Well, Anderson hasn't played that much and hasn't scored that much.
Well, this is only his fifth game since he regained his eligibility.
Nice technique shooter.
63-59. Van Anderson went to St. Anthony's High School in Long Beach. 6'4", 190, and a junior. 63-59, UNLV. 11 minutes left. And it goes to Butler, knocked away from him. Loose ball, and it's picked up by Anderson. And they call jump ball, alternate possession. It'll be out of bounds to UNLV. It's going to be out of bounds to Fullerton.
Fullerton looked like
UNLV, I'm sorry.
Watch the seam. Let's see the seam.
Here is Butler with the right hand. Butler with a short hook.
You know, it's no different in playing against a basketball zone than it is in football. You just get in between two defenders, and they've done that very successfully.
UNLV applying pressure. Butler has 17 points. In it comes to Van Anderson, who had to act as a safety valve. Rashawn Lewis says he doesn't want the ball, but he's going to have to bring it up anyway. Still doesn't have it across the timeline. Now he does.
10. They made it.
Hill. Williams. 65-59. Williams pushes it up, and it's knocked away by Ackles. And a follow-up by Sykes. No good. Sykes has missed two underneath now.
All he's doing is taking his eye off the basket. As it,
I think he becomes so intent on jamming.
Yes. Now watch Sykes. Let's see if he drops his head as he goes. If,
well, he took a lick in the chops, one thing.
That might have had some effect on him.
I think it might have, yes.
Yeah.
Foul is on Ackles.
Well, he's upset with himself because he's had a chance to put four more points on the board.
10.5 minutes left. Ooh, just did get the roll. 65-60, UNLV. Clint Rossum is in. Going out, Greg Anthony. Sykes tonight came in averaging just under 4 points a game, and he has four right now to go with his four rebounds.
Well, what Fullerton's managed to do is to keep the game close with Sabalas in foul trouble. If they go another 2 or 3 minutes with the game like this and the score like this, I think we'll see Cedric Sabalas in the game again.
He's been on the bench now for 2.5, 3 minutes. Four fouls, Sabalas. Rossum to Hunt.
Again, they're in a 2-3 zone. They'll either slide in from behind the zone in the middle of the court, or they'll go baseline.
There's Rossum with a jumper. Rebounded by Sykes. He's fouled by Butler over the top.
Well, Sykes has really mixed it up since he's been in the ballgame. He's been a real important factor.
Derrick Jones will return for Cal State Fullerton.
Sykes came to the weak side board, did a great job of shielding off. Butler had no chance to get inside.
So Sykes with 5 points in the game. And coming back in is Ray Young for UNLV. He will go in for George Ackles.
Young's a good outside shooter. A little bit better shooter than the other frontline players for Las Vegas.
65-61. This place is like a sauna bath in here. 65-62. Sykes is 4 out of 4 at the line.
Well, Fullerton has managed to stop Las Vegas's momentum, and it seemed to be edging in the other direction.
So Fullerton getting some help from an unexpected source, John Sykes. He doesn't score that much. Sykes putting in a couple of free throws. Fullerton trails by 2. Hunt to Young.
Again, they're in their matchup zone.
Young will take the shot. Rebounded hard by Derrick Jones for Fullerton.
He's had a real game tonight.
The Titans could tie this trip down. 9.5 minutes remaining at 65-63, UNLV leading Cal State Fullerton. Mike Walden and Ted Owens, there's the shot by Hill, and a foul call by referee Terry Tackett.
Well,
foul is on Clint Rossum.
Mark Hill with a spin dribble, and Rossum just ran under him. He didn't foul him with his upper body, but he moved under him.
Hill's pretty good free throw shooter, and Derek Tarkanian knows that as well as John Sneed. Hill is 69% at the line. 3 out of 3 at the line tonight.
Well, we could have a tie game.
65-64. 9 minutes, 29 seconds remaining. It's deadlock. 65 all. Sellout crowd, 4,000 here at Titan Gym.
And Fullerton's alive. You can see a move on defense. They can smell a possible victory against this great Vegas team.
Butler loses it, but Butler is fouled. The foul is on Williams, Wayne Williams. That's 3 now on Williams. And 16 fouls.
Butler
against
slides
Fullerton.
Inside. Fullerton's all around him. Hill reached in and fouled.
UNLV 65. Fullerton 65. Into Butler.
Vegas has not shot the ball well outside, and so Fullerton's going to their collapsing zone. When the ball goes inside, they're really pinching in a hurry.
Anderson Hunt, Clint Rossum. Rossum wants the ball. And Richie Ballesteros has the foul, and it's against UNLV. It's on Rossum, I think.
Clint Rossum saw a hole in the defense, penetrated. Look at John Sykes, moved over in front of him, took the blow, takes a lot of guts, but John Sykes has done a terrific job.
The foul on Clint Rossum of UNLV, his third. Greg Anthony back in, replacing Rossum. Anthony, the point guard, returns for the Rebels.
When Clint Rossum penetrated, he should have gone straight up, but he was leaning in. And Sykes just moved over in front and planted both feet and took the blow.
Sykes is 5 out of 5 at the free throw line. He'll shoot the 1-1. Game tied at 65. Just under 9 minutes left. 66-65. It's the first time Fullerton has been in the lead since the Titans led at 33-32.
Sykes came out of Merced High
School. Got both of them. 67-65. 7 points for John Sykes. And John Steed's team is ahead. 67-65.
Look Altman. At him support inside. They're going to make him shoot it outside.
The shot no good by Hunt. Underneath, no good by Augman. And Augman is really belted by Van Anderson. Or check it, it's Ray Young underneath.
They're not shooting the ball well outside, but they're really rebounding it well. Barry Young goes up, and they hack him to put him at the line. But he's a pretty good shooter. 80% free throw shooter.
Van Anderson commits the foul, his second. Young is out of Ellicott City, Maryland. Misses the free throw.
Listen to this hand for John Sykes.
David Moody has replaced Sykes. Van Anderson is out. Sabalos is back in for Fullerton. 8:41 to play.
John Snead said the game's now.
67-66, Fullerton by one. Pressure by UNLV. Mark Hill brings it up against Anderson Hunt.
Las Vegas has not been as successful in forcing turnovers in this ball game as they did in the previous encounter.
Sabalos.
101.
Hill for three. Heartbreak for Mark Hill and Cal State Fullerton. Augman with the rebound.
Good open shot.
A 1-point lead for Fullerton at 67-66. 8 minutes to play.
Fullerton has stayed with that zone the whole game.
Anderson Hunt misses. Right back over to Hunt. Hunt drives in, doesn't score it. Moody has it for Fullerton.
Moody made Anderson Hunt change hands with the ball.
Sabalos. Augman is on him. Cedric shot. No. And we got
Moody's
a foul underneath. And it'll be against David Moody. The fifth foul on David Moody. And right away, Sykes will get back in there for Cal State Fullerton. That may be a plus for the Titans.
You bet, the way Sykes has been playing.
And Randall Moose also back in for
Penetration
Fullerton.
Penetration by Sabalos here. Moody reached in all over their backs.
So Moody fouls out with 7 minutes and 42 seconds to play.
Sabalos.
Ray Young will be at the free throw line. 67-66. Fullerton. And the crowd will try to make it tough on Ray Young, trying to distract him. Didn't work. 67 apiece. So even though the Rebels have had their trouble at the free throw line tonight, Young was able to make his last two.
Well, he's an 80% shooter.
Now he's made three in a row. And UNLV is back into the lead, 68-67. 7:42 to play. And what a game this has been. Big West Conference game between UNLV and Cal State Fullerton.
The challenge, to sell an unbelievable 300 new and used cars in February. Right now, Harbor Hyundai South Coast Dodge Isuzu Peugeot in Costa Mesa will do anything to meet the challenge. We've got over 500 new Hyundai Dodge Isuzu Peugeots, all priced to move. The challenge, drive home any new 1988 for $88 below invoice. Hyundai Dodge Isuzu, $88 below invoice.
That's with no money down.
Hurry to Harbor Hyundai South Coast Dodge Isuzu Peugeot in Costa Mesa.
Pepperdine, UC Santa Barbara, as well as national powerhouses North Carolina and Nevada, Las Vegas, make this a season of greatness. College basketball on Prime Ticket. It's sports television at its best. Over 1,000 athletes get ready to compete in the Coca-Cola National Sprint Triathlon. Some of the best male and female triathletes will be there. So will Prime Ticket. So join us for the Coca-Cola National Sprint Triathlon.
Tonight's game is brought to you by Toyota. Quality right down the line. Who could ask for anything more? Toyota. And by Great Western's family of companies with over $32 billion in assets, 100 years strong. We'll always be there. And we're glad to be here tonight at Titan Gym in Fullerton, California. Along the Prime Ticket Network, Jerry Tarkanian's UNLV Running Rebels, number 19 in the nation, getting a real battle and challenge tonight from the Titans of Cal State Fullerton. Foul is on Greg Anthony. Blocking foul. He didn't get over in time.
And they're in a penalty. That's a 1-1. Anderson didn't quite have position. Wayne Williams did a nice job.
First time that Williams has been at the free throw line tonight. The Titans have converted 16 out of 19 at the line.
That's kept them in the ball game.
Game's tied at 68. On the other side of the coin, UNLV, 17 out of 32 at the line. Three fouls, by the way, on Greg Anthony, the point guard of the Rebels. Williams gets just one out of the two. Tied at 68. 7.5 minutes to go. Anthony, Anderson, Hunt.
Fullerton has stayed with their matchup zone throughout. Las Vegas has not been able to shoot the ball in outside at all.
Anthony puts up a 14-footer and cans it. Greg Anthony. UNLV back into the lead, 70 to 68. And Jones is down. Derrick Jones. His leg might have cramped up a little bit.
The way he's holding on, I think that he is cramping.
Well, I've been talking about this all night long, the humidity inside of the Titan Gym. It's like a sauna bath, and it's been cold in the Southern California area the last couple of days. They must have left the heat on. It's really warm. 70-68 UNLV. Into Sabalos, back over to Williams.
Williams in a one-on-one situation has really not lost the ball much tonight.
Sabalos with four fouls. Into Jones, the fadeaway. No, Sykes underneath. Sykes puts it up, doesn't get it, but he's fouled. Augman got him, or it might have been Barry Young.
I think it was Augman, but look how John Sykes positions himself on the weak side board. Look at him move himself. He just knocked the offensive players right out of their defense. Big, strong guy.
The foul is on Stacy Augman. That is his third, but that's only part of the story. Augman drew two personal fouls in the first 45 seconds of this game. And just now, with 7 minutes left in the contest, or 6:53, does he get his third?
No, he has cut down his aggressiveness on defense. But I just marvel at how well John Sykes, you know, he came transfer from University of Texas, although he's a native Californian from Merced.
Misses both free throws. And it's taken down by Butler. So it's still a 2-point lead for UNLV.
Well, those were two big free throws.
Sykes may be running out of gas, too. The fatigue factor could be setting in.
Well, he's not accustomed to playing this long.
70-68 UNLV. 6.5 minutes remaining. Anthony from outside. Air ball. And it'll be out of bounds to Fullerton. Touched last by Ray Young.
Las Vegas outside shooting has been awful tonight.
70-68.
This has allowed Fullerton to really support inside.
Mark Hill looking inside for Sabalos. Hill will take the shot. Sabalos reaching over the back, and let's see. No, it's Rashawn Lewis.
Yeah, they're lucky it wasn't Sabalos.
It's a push.
Good penetration by Mark Hill. They might have raked him across the arm. Yeah, it was over the back. No question, they had Vegas had very good inside position.
George Eccles back in for UNLV. Ray Young goes out. And Marlon Vaughn coming in for Fullerton, replacing Wayne Williams. I think John Sneed's got to get Williams out of there and give him a bit of a breather. 6:03 left.
It's when he's your primary ball handler with 6 minutes to go. You know, just 1 minute could be a big difference in the ball game.
Augman makes it 71-68, UNLV. And Derrick Jones returns for Fullerton. Rashawn Lewis goes out.
But you made an important point here, Mike, is they have not rested, Fullerton has not rested their guards tonight.
Augman misses the second free throw.
Jones positioned Eccles out very well.
So the deficit for Cal State Fullerton is 3. It's 71-68. Marlon Vaughn being fronted there hard by Greg Anthony, all over him. Mark Hill, and Hill loses the ball, but it was touched last by Anderson Hunt.
When he caught the ball, he exposed it in front of himself there, and as a result, almost lost it.
71-68 into Hill.
Vegas has stayed man for man throughout. Fullerton has been zoned throughout. Again, Sabalos.
Off-balance shot.
Did not square up.
Sykes saves it to Mark Hill. And he almost throws it away.
He's truly Johnny on the spot.
Marlon Vaughn to Derrick Jones. 71-68. Jones puts it up. No. Taken off by Butler. Over to Greg Anthony. Three-point lead, UNLV. Oh, and the pass hit Butler right in the face. Sykes down to Sabalos. He will slam it. One-point lead, UNLV. 5 minutes left. Sabalos has 19. A steal by Jones.
What's happening? Las Vegas can't shoot the ball in outside, and Fullerton's really getting back in. They're really
Sabalos,
supporting.
Yes! A three-pointer! 73-71 with 4.5 minutes left. Fullerton on top. Butler. Anderson Hunt short. Rebound Jones.
Sabalos was open down the court.
Marlon Vaughn has it slapped away by Anthony. The crowd on its feet here at Titan Gym, a sellout throng of 4,000, and Jerry Tarkanian's 19th ranked UNLV running Rebels trail it by 2. 4:24 left in the game, and listen to this crowd in Fullerton, California.
The 1989 Toyota Camry. Comfort. Room. Toyota quality. One more thing for 89. Camry has room with a great view.
My Toyota, I have it.
On a clear day, you can see Mount Shasta 100 miles away. Sure makes everything else look mighty small. Kind of like Great Western Bank, big and strong. You see, nowadays, the Great Western family of companies stands for over $32 billion in assets and the security of federal insurance.
They've been keeping folks' money safe for 100 years now. So you know Great Western's going to be there for a long time to come. For sheer size and strength, it sure stands out.
Oh, you can feel the heat here in Fullerton, and you'll be able to feel it on Tuesday as the Los Angeles Lakers, minus Magic Johnson, battle Isaiah Thomas and the Detroit Pistons in the Great Western Forum. Live coverage begins at 7 o'clock, beginning with Lakers Tonight. The Lakers and Prime Ticket, sports television at its best. Appears that Magic is going to be out about 7 to 10 days. That's the last report I heard.
And he makes all the difference in the world. Los Angeles really has some problems when he's not in the ballgame. Jerry Tarkanian has to be very concerned. This is a fired-up Fullerton team. The thing that's really impressed me is that this front line of Fullerton has not been intimidated by Las Vegas at all. Jones.
Go ahead.
Jones, Sykes, Sabalas, all of them inside have done a great job in competing on the board.
Sabalas will inbound it for Cal State Fullerton. And it goes off the leg of Augment. He was about to be whistled on the 5 second. Smart heads-up play by Sabalas.
Yes. The defense had turned his back on Sabalas. He couldn't inbound it, so he just threw it off of the backside of the defender.
Williams is fouled by Greg Anthony. Four fouls on the UNLV point guard, Anthony.
Well, as quick as Las Vegas is, they have not been able to stop the penetration of the Fullerton guard. Great penetration by Williams. Greg Anthony just trailed him all the way.
Wayne Williams will go to the free throw line. He will shoot two. Williams is one out of two at the free throw line.
I thought coming into this game, if it gets to be a free throw contest, Fullerton will win the ball game.
Not that way.
Not that way is right.
Fullerton is shooting as a team only 67% at the line, and UNLV 62%, worst in the Big West Conference. Still 73-71. Williams gets this one. 74-71. Fullerton, 4 minutes and change left. Here is Sabalas. Traveling is the call. A tough break for Cal State Fullerton.
I don't know what Anthony was trying to do then. I didn't see anyone open, did you?
No. Three-point lead for Fullerton. Rossum to Anthony.
I don't expect Fullerton to spread out too far, but they did.
Anthony misses. Augment follows with the right hand. 74-73. Fullerton's lead is down to one.
Fullerton should not spread their zone out. Williams is coming away too far because I can't remember when they've hit an outside shot.
Sabalas to Williams. Jones.
Vegas trying to pick up
into Sabalas. Rejected nicely by Ackles. Ackles skying to swap that one away. Down at the other end. There is Ackles. And we got a foul underneath. And Jones motions to the bench, the Fullerton bench. He's got to come out.
Good penetration. Watch Ackles come from nowhere to block that shot. Great defensive play.
The foul is number four on Wayne Williams.
Beautiful pass by Rossum, and they put Ackles at the line. Big, big free throw. Flipped it nicely.
74 all. Ackles, who is only a 47% free throw shooter, at the line for UNLV. But he's made three out of four tonight. 3 minutes, 19 seconds remaining. Gets both of them, and UNLV takes a 75-74 lead over Fullerton.
It doesn't matter whether you rattle them in or whatever, it still counts.
Mark Hill. Wayne Williams.
Sabalas,
yeah, he's off to the right side now to Mark Hill. Sabalas goes for the baseline. There's the shot. No, but a follow-up by John Sykes.
What
John Sykes. 76-75 Fullerton. 2:50 to play.
It's wonderful to see an athlete become totally inspired. That's what Sykes has been.
Rossum. Rebounded by Augman, who puts it in. Stacy Augman, 77-76, UNLV. 2.5 minutes left. Wayne Williams with it. Gives off over to Mark Hill. Hill for three. Doesn't get it. Butler has it for UNLV.
Fatigue could have been a factor in that. You're shooting outside when you become a little bit tired. You lose your edge just a little bit. And it looked like Mark Hill was short all the way.
Stacy Augman, the leading scorer for UNLV. 24 points in the game. 77-76. The Rebels by one. 2 minutes to play. Exactly two.
They're sagging. They're going to make them shoot the ball outside.
Butler.
And no one wants to.
Here is Greg Anthony, and he cans it. Anthony for 3 points.
Can you believe that?
80-76. Yes, I can believe it, because it was Anthony who beat Fullerton in mid-January on a 23-foot shot that just beat the buzzer, and he banked it in. 80-76. UNLV. Sabalos. 80-78.
Well, he answered, didn't he? Let's see if Tark uses up the 45 seconds.
120 to go in the game. It's a 2-point ball game in favor of UNLV.
If he uses up the 45 seconds, even if Fullerton comes down and scores, they're going to have the last shot at this game.
Sabalos with 24 points, Augman with 24, the leaders for their two teams.
The key to it, they need to attack the zone aggressively now.
15 on the shot clock and a foul against Mark Hill of Cal State Fullerton. 3 on Hill.
And they fouled the wrong man. They fouled one of their better free throw shooters.
Greg Anthony, 74%. And Anthony will be at the line with a 1-1. Anthony has made 1 out of 2 at the line tonight. 53 seconds remaining.
Well, if he hits both of them, it puts them out of the risk of one possession, giving Fullerton or giving a tie game.
Steve wants the timeout, and he gets it. 53 seconds left. 3-point margin, UNLV. We'll be right back here at Titan Gym.
Well, you probably won't believe it, but I have 407,510 miles.
98,398 miles. My Toyota truck. I love it.
101,978 miles.
213,000 miles.
126,672 miles. My Toyota truck. I love it.
And I love it.
I really love it.
1 mile, and I already love it.
Who could ask for anything more?
If you're a sports fan, you ought to know about the King Slap Shop. Located in Westchester near the LA airport, the Slap Shop has everything you'll need to dress like a king. You'll find the best in hockey fashion, from authentic jerseys to t-shirts, sweaters, jackets, and more. You'll also find hats, decals, pennants, and other hockey souvenirs. The King Slap Shop, 8808 South Sepulveda in Westchester, located in the All-Year Sports Den. Call for a free catalog, area code 213-215-1084.
Being in a close game is nothing new for UNLV. They've had a very difficult schedule this year. They have lost 5 games. 3 out of the 5 have been by 2 points or less. And right now, UNLV leading by 3, 81-78.
Well, they have much more experience in terms of being successful in winning close basketball games, and that could be a real important factor here.
Well, you think they've played Oklahoma twice, Arizona. They play North Carolina State Sunday. Greg Anthony makes it 82-78. So is it going to be close but no cigar again for Fullerton? Well, that's been the history of the Titans against UNLV in the last 6 years.
Las Vegas does not want to foul here. Fullerton wants to score right away and then get a timeout so they can organize their full court pressure.
Sabalos kicks it off over to Jones, back over to Sabalos, underneath, and he scores it.
Timeout.
82-80, and a timeout is called, 31 seconds left. A Fullerton timeout, 31 seconds left, and a 2-point game.
Well, John Snead called a timeout when Las Vegas Greg Anthony was at the free throw line, just simply to remind them that after they score, try to get a quick basket and then call a timeout so you can organize your defense. It'll be interesting. They've been allowing Las Vegas to throw the ball in. Now they may jump the ball out of bounds. They have to get the ball, obviously, back here as quickly as possible. On the other hand, John Steen might be saying, here are three or four guys you can foul right away. If Ackles touches the ball, if Butler touches the ball, put him at the line.
And now you're looking in at the huddle of Jerry Tarkanian. They're up early tomorrow morning to grab a plane to go back east against North Carolina State Sunday afternoon.
Well, Jerry obviously wants to remind his player that he can run the inline after a score, or he's telling him, if you can't get the ball inbounds, be sure and use a timeout. Let's don't lose the ball out of bounds right now. Once you get it in, penetrate, get the ball moved around, get it moved around quickly so we won't get fouled.
Our producer tonight, Dennis Kirkpatrick, we would remind you that we will have San Jose State, UC Santa Barbara, from Santa Barbara, 5 o'clock live on the Prime Ticket Television Network Saturday. Hope you can join us at that time.
They're short-stopping it.
Comes it over to Anthony, and he's fouled by Mark Hill. That'll stop the clock, 28 seconds left.
Jerry Tarkanian, that's the man he wanted to get the ball to. Greg Anthony's a very good free throw shooter, and so Hill fouled him. It's obviously, John Sneed wanted someone else to handle the ball.
Greg Anthony, a 6'1 sophomore, a transfer from the University of Portland, goes to the line. This could be the game right here. 82-80, UNLV.
Let's see if John Sneed will use a timeout to ice him. He may save his timeout so after they score, they can organize their pressure.
No timeout. Sneed is up yelling, rebound, rebound. He missed the shot. A three-pointer could send it into overtime. 25 seconds left, 83-80, but 24 seconds when the timeout is called by Cal State Fullerton.
I don't believe they'll allow them to shoot to the three-pointer. I think they'll make them penetrate to the basket. I think that since you can foul a man shooting a three-point shot, they won't get a dead-open three-point shot.
Let's see if we can eavesdrop on John Sneed and Cal State Fullerton. I don't think we can get our sound John microphone in there. John
Sneed has one of two choices. He has to go for.
Don't give any three-point shot.
You heard Jerry Tarkanian say don't give him a three-point shot. They're going to make him drive for anything.
If indeed it is set up for a three-pointer, I would guess the man to shoot it for Fullerton would be Mark Hill. He's 45% from three-point range, and Hill has made a couple of three-pointers tonight, four to be exact.
I would think that it would be Mark Hill, but I think if they can't get a three-pointer, they should drive to the basket, get a quick two-pointer, get timeout again, and make Vegas go to the free throw line on the other end of the court.
But first, Fullerton has to inbound the ball and bring it across the timeline. 83-80, UNLV. Ceballos will inbound it.
Vegas leaving a safety. They're going to put pressure on the ball.
Williams brings it up against Anthony.
They're certainly not intending to let them have a three-point shot, but Mark Hill's going to get one.
A three-pointer by Hill. No, it's taken off by Ceballos. Ceballos back at the three-point line. His shot. No! A follow-up by Sykes over to Jones. His three-pointer is up. Yes! Traveling is called against Anthony. 1 second to go.
And John,
would you believe that's the first three-pointer that Derrick Jones has made this season? He was 0 for 2 from three-point land, and he just tied the game at 83 with 1 second to go.
John Sykes was the key to all of this. A shot from outside. Another shot by Ceballos. Now watch John Sykes. Quick thinking. He gets it out to Derrick, and Derrick bombs it. Great thinking by John Sykes. Great thinking by Derek Jones.
Now watch Anthony, a little bit out of control right here. Traveling against Anthony, it'll be out of bounds to Fullerton at midcourt with 1 second left. Now that's 1 second showing on the scoreboard clock. Maybe there's a little bit more than 1 second. The game is not over until the buzzer.
Yeah, it could be almost 2 seconds. I think they'll try to get a little depth to their pass. They may try to throw it up around the rim in hopes. Let's see, there's John Snead throwing one up right now. They're going to screen down. They're going to have John Sykes screen down, it looks like, for Sabalas. I think that Jerry Tarkanian will have his men jump the ball so they can't throw an accurate pass. John Sykes is going to screen down for Sabalas and bring him up to the head of the circle for the shot.
John Sykes has had 11 rebounds for Fullerton, 7 defensive, 4 offensive.
Oh, he's done a tremendous job. Watch here, Sykes is going to screen for Sabalas, but I believe that Anthony will switch it. I think they'll switch the down screen.
Wayne Williams will inbound. Sabalas puts it up. We go into overtime. And I want to tell you something. Mike Walden and Ted Owens know all about overtimes. Last Saturday, we had 3 overtimes. Fresno State finally beating UOP at the Spano Center in Stockton. And we go into an overtime here in Fullerton, California.
The 1989 Toyota Camry. Comfort. Room. Toyota quality. One more thing for 89. Camry has room with a great view.
My Toyota, I love it.
On a clear day, you can see Mount Shasta 100 miles away. Sure makes everything else look mighty small. Kind of like Great Western Bank, big and strong. You see, nowadays, the Great Western family of companies stands for over $32 billion in assets and the security of federal insurance. They've been keeping folks' money safe for 100 years now. So you know Great Western's gonna be there for a long time to come. For sheer size and strength, it sure stands out.
As we head into this overtime, Mike Walden and Ted Owens, I would remind you of the fact each team gets an extra timeout now in the overtime period, which means that UNLV has 2 remaining and Fullerton 1. The only time you have a jump ball is to start the game and each overtime period, and David Butler will jump for UNLV against Derrick Jones for Fullerton. 83 all at the end of regulation time. Grabbed off by Sykes. Williams. It's been 6 years since Fullerton beat UNLV. Sykes almost lost it. Ackles coming out to challenge. Off to Derrick Jones.
They're spreading their offense. Las Vegas has been vulnerable to the penetration. Here goes Wayne Williams.
Williams lays it off, and Sykes scores! John Sykes, 85-83.
Well, you can bet Fullerton's gonna be back in that zone.
Into Ackles. Ackles' bank shot ties the game at 85.
Ackles found a crack in the zone. Anthony did a good job getting the ball to him.
Williams up court for Fullerton. Park getting ready to send in Anderson Hunt. Sykes off the hill.
Yeah, John Sykes has to be very careful. He's picking up his pivot foot.
Jones in the corner. gets it to Mark Hill. Hill loses the ball, out of bounds to UNLV. Here comes Anderson Henning for the Rebels.
Well, Mark caught himself in the worst place you can have the ball, along the baseline. Just didn't have any room to operate.
Rashawn Lewis back in for Fullerton. So Fullerton now setting up on defense. It looks like it's a 2-3 zone. Williams, Hill, Lewis, Sykes, and Sabalas.
It is a 2-3. They'll match up in front depending on how many players that Las Vegas has outside.
We're in the overtime period, tied at 85. Anthony shot. No. Butler, and Butler scores. UNLV back on top, 87-85 in the OT. 21 points for David Butler.
Offensive rebounding has kept Las Vegas in the game. They haven't shot the ball well outside. They haven't shot it well at the free throw line, but they've stayed in with offensive rebound.
Rashawn Lewis. Williams. Williams ties it at 87. 3 minutes to go in the OT.
I don't think I've ever seen Las Vegas guards whipped as much as they have been tonight on penetration, dribble penetration.
Butler puts it up and scores. David Butler, 89-87. 2:40 to go in the overtime.
Vegas plays a very aggressive defense, but when you're tired or about a half step behind, there they go again.
Williams, follow up Sykes, no. And it's grabbed off by UNLV.
What a valiant effort, though, by John Sykes.
Ogman grabbing that rebound for the Rebels. 89-87, the University of Nevada, Las Vegas. Hunt, Ogman. Anthony goes for three. Rebound, Sabalos for Fullerton. 2-point lead at 89-87. UNLV on top. Sabalos has it touched last by Ogman. Out of bounds, Fullerton in front of the Cal State Fullerton bench. Derek Jones will come in. Rashawn Lewis goes out.
Sabalos has been rather quiet in the overtime, and a part of that is that Stacey Ogman now is guarding him again. He only has three fouls, and he's guarding him closely, keeping the ball out of his hand.
Ooh, Jones had to retrieve. That ball was headed out of bounds. Sabalos, the leading scorer for Fullerton with 26. Williams off to Cedric Sabalos. There he goes. Puts it up, hoping to draw the foul. No such luck. The ball is picked up by Jones. And they call traveling.
No, they
was that alternate possession?
Yes, alternate possession.
89-87, UNLV with a minute and a half to go.
Fullerton was able to get the tap at the beginning of the overtime, and so it's Las Vegas next possession.
Greg Anthony has it up court.
Back to the zone again. They've stayed in the zone throughout the game.
.115 to go in the overtime. 2-point lead, UNLV, 89-87. Into Butler. Butler out to Anderson Hunt. Over the top, out of bounds, Fullerton. 66 seconds left. Look at Tark.
Yeah, Anderson Hunt ordinarily is a good outside shooter, but he has not experienced a good night tonight. There's Mark Hill for three.
Yes! 1-point Fullerton lead, 90-89. Fullerton, 45 seconds in the overtime. Hunt over to Butler. Butler has it rejected by Sykes. They called goaltending on John Sykes. The basket goes to David Butler. It's 91-90, UNLV.
Butler found a seam, came in from behind the defense. That ball was on the way. Sykes caught it on the way down. Very good call, officials on top of it. Defensive goaltending.
Mark Hill, who's 5 out of 7 in three-point shots tonight, is bumped by Hunt, and Hill will go to the line. Mark Hill is a 69% free throw shooter. But I think Hill's better from three-point range than he is at the free throw line.
He is. Good penetration. Anderson Hunt is hugging him. He reached in, Look how he has his left arm in his stomach. So Mark Hill's in position to put Fullerton ahead.
Foul on Anderson Hunt. Coming up next, racing from Santa Anita, right here on the Prime Ticket Network. And if they have finishes at Santa Anita today, like we are having to this one, boy, you don't want to miss that. 91-90 is the score. UNLV up by one. Van Anderson is in. Sabalos will go out in the final 26 seconds. Sabalos shaking his head. I don't think he wanted to come out. But Sabalos now has four fouls. Who knows? We could go into another overtime. Hill misses. First time he's missed at the free throw line. And it'll be out of bounds to UNLV.
John Snead wants a timeout.
It seems like this Cal State Fullerton team has been so close so many times against UNLV in the last 6 years. But the only victory they have was 6 years ago, Leon Wood and Fullerton doing it to UNLV. 24 seconds left in the overtime.
Well, you probably won't believe it, but I have 407,510 miles.
98,398 miles. My Toyota truck. I love it.
101,978 miles.
213,000 miles.
126,672 miles. My Toyota truck. I love it.
And I love it.
I really love it.
1 mile, and I already love it.
Who could ask for anything more?
If you're a sports fan, you ought to know about the King Slap Shop. Located in Westchester near the LA airport, the Slap Shop has everything you'll need to dress like a king. You'll find the best in hockey fashion, from authentic jerseys to t-shirts, sweaters, jackets, and more. You'll also find hats, decals, pennants, and other hockey souvenirs. The King Slap Shop, 8808 South Sepulveda in Westchester, located in the All Year Sports Den. Call for a free catalog, area code 213-215-1084.
Cedric Sabalos, Wayne Williams, and Mark Hill all playing with four personal fouls for Cal State Fullerton. And it's a one-point lead for the running Rebels, who battle North Carolina State Sunday afternoon in North Carolina.
John Snead apparently took Sabalos out of the ball game to protect him on fouls. The only problem with that is they may not get possession of the ball again. And Sabalos is third in the league in stolen balls.
If you're going to foul, you should either foul, I guess, Ackles or Butler.
And this may be his intent.
And Terry Tackett says, wait a minute. Van Anderson got in there along with Mark Hill. And the foul is on Anthony. The foul is on.
Well, let's take a look. I can't. He may have said they called timeout before the 5 seconds.
Well, Tackett came over and he says red 5-0. He wouldn't announce the player's number if it's a timeout, would he, Ted Owens?
Unless he's saying 5-0 was calling timeout.
That could be.
5-0 is Greg Anthony, and he was calling a timeout.
Well, we can't pick up Coach Tarkanian in the huddle, but UNLV leading 91-90 over Fullerton, 24 seconds left in the overtime, and I'm guessing it's Fullerton's, or rather UNLV's ball out of bounds, although Terry Tackett came over and he said red 50, and that would indicate to me a foul, but I'll wait and see.
Sure, Tarkanian diagrammed the play to be sure they were able to inbound it.
Now Terry Tackett gives us a signal saying that it's out of bounds to UNLV.
One thing that's really important here is for that player, Ackles, taking the ball out, to remember that he cannot run the inline. It's a spot throw-in. The reason they took Sabalos out, they're going to foul anyway right away.
You don't want to foul Anthony, though.
No.
So Anthony gets it up.
But what do you do if he keeps it in his hand? Run 5 second count.
Eventually, you're going to have to foul him. Clint Rossum is a good free throw shooter. He's handling the ball. They two-timing off to Augman. Clock is down to 8 seconds. Ackles is fouled, but they don't let it go, and now the foul is called.
Too long.
They tried to foul Ackles, and Ackles was fouled, but the whistle didn't blow.
again, Las Vegas has been in so many close ball games that they respond in a very positive way under those kind of, that kind of pressure. And Jerry Tarkanian wants a timeout.
4 seconds left in the overtime. It's 91 to 90. And Tark might be thinking to himself, hey, I lost a one-pointer down to Bill Mulligan and UC Irvine Saturday night at the Brin Center. Maybe I'm about ready to win a one-pointer here.
Well, the only thing bad about taking a timeout with 4 seconds to go is that you almost ice your own player. If he stays over there and waits for a minute, he has a lot of time to think about that free throw. I think Jerry's probably thinking, we hope they can't score in 4 seconds, so we're going to take our chance.
And he's probably right.
I think probably that John Snead had taken Sabalas out of the game for defensive reasons, not because he isn't a good defender, but he didn't want Sabalas to foul out. And I would guess that Sabalas will be back in with 4 seconds to go. Well, let's see if Greg Anthony's bothered by the 1 minute that he had to wait while they were in the huddle. It'll be Stacey Ogman, excuse me.
UNLV has out-rebounded Fullerton 50-33 in the game. 17 extra boards for UNLV.
Well,
Ogman's going to be at the line.
You have one of two choices Jerry Tarkanian has. He can get his men back on defense, or he can put them up on the line in the event that Stacey Ogman misses and they have a chance to rebound it.
He's got three men back, Rossum, Ackles, and Butler. Ogman is 3 out of 6 of the line, and that should make it 92-90, and it does. UNLV with 4 seconds to go. Look at Snead. Tells it all.
They're going to pressure right away. They're going to pressure the ball down the court.
There goes comes Williams. He's got to hurry. Puts it up. Yay! Watch it again. The three-pointer by Wayne Williams. And Fullerton has defeated UNLV for the first time in 6 years, for the first time in 16 games, 93-92. And it was here just Saturday night against Santa Barbara that Williams hit a 35-footer to beat the buzzer at the end of the first half. And then Fullerton went on to beat Santa Barbara. And it was Williams who put up, what, about a 30-foot shot?
Jerry Tarkanian had put his men back on defense. I'm a little surprised they didn't come up and challenge the shot.
You had to see the shock on the face of Jerry Tarkanian. He was stunned. At first, I don't believe that his eyes could believe what he just saw.
No, but I do believe the shot was up in plenty of time.
A 35-foot shot by Wayne Williams. And right away, John Snead got a kiss from his wife, John Snead, and Fullerton, 93-92 over UNLV.
Gretzky, all alone, in front, he shoots, he scores!
Attention fans, the Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers proudly announced the On the Road with the Kings contest. You could win a new Mitsubishi Mighty Max 4x4 truck courtesy of your Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers. You'll also join the Los Angeles Kings on a road trip when they battle the New Jersey Devils and New York Rangers in late February. You'll fly round trip to New York courtesy of today's TWA. Find out how good they are to New York and stay at the beautiful Sheraton Center provided by Sheraton, the hospitality people of ITT. To enter, fill out the entry form available at your participating Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers or send your name, address, and phone number on a postcard to On the Road with the Kings, 401 South Prairie, Suite 104, Inglewood, California, 90301. Entries must be received by February 15th.
Nichols to Duchesne, he scores!
Don't get shut out. Break away to your participating Southern California Mitsubishi Motors dealers and enter today.
Snake River, Wyoming and Old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. The Snake River means fly fishing for Lunker cutthroat trout. And Old Milwaukee means a great beer. Cold, crisp Old Milwaukee beer. And smooth, golden Old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place. An Old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee light.
Fellas, it just doesn't get any better than this.
Want to find out the scores of the day, the fast-breaking sports news, and the people who make it? Then you want Prime Ticket Daily News Dial Sports. It's the fastest, easiest way to find out game analysis, weather information, player injuries, and with up-to-the-minute reporting 24 hours a day with fresh updates every 5 minutes. Plus, find out what's on Prime Ticket tonight. Just call 213-976-1313. Prime Ticket Daily News Dial Sports.
The celebration continues here at Titan Gym. You would have thought that the Titans had just won the NCAA tournament. Oh, they're going to be partying into the wee hours of the morning here in Orange County. And it's turnabout fair play. January the 16th, Anthony beat the buzzer for UNLV and banked in a 23-foot shot. UNLV beat Fullerton 66-63. Tonight, it was Wayne Williams that beat the buzzer in the overtime, a 35-foot three-pointer. And Fullerton finally gets the monkey, the UNLV monkey, off its back with a victory over the Rebels on that shot as the three zeros came into view. Wayne Williams and Fullerton, 93-92 over UNLV. So the Rebels are now 15-6 overall, 10-2 in the Big West Conference. Fullerton 10-10 overall, 5-6 in the Big West.
Oh, it was a terrific basketball game. There are a lot of heroes. Sabalas played so well early. Jones played well early. But a guy that really gave him a lift was John Sykes in the second half.
Sykes wound up with 13 points. Sabalas 26 points to lead the winners. 93-92 over UNLV. UNLV losing by one. Cal State Fullerton 93-92 here at Titan Gym. For Ted Owens, this is Mike Walden saying so long. Thanks for being with us along the Prime Ticket Network.
Prime Ticket has presented exciting collegiate basketball action featuring the Big West Conference. Brought to you by Stroh's and Stroh Life. Now you're talking good times and Stroh's is spoken here. By your Southern California Chevrolet dealers. Come in and test drive the Chevy of your dreams, then drive home with the deal of a lifetime. By Great Western's family of companies with over $30 billion in assets. 100 years strong, we'll always be there. And by Toyota. Quality right down the line. Who could ask for anything more? Toyota.
You're formally invited to a night of showtime, courtesy of Prime Ticket. Get ready, because we're coming at you.
Times Fullerton State's going to attempt the triple, and finally Derrick Jones gets it to go with 5 seconds to go, sends it to overtime. There, a two-point Rebels lead. Stacey Ogman misses the free throw, and Wayne Williams, yes, it counts! And the Titans of Fullerton State beat UNLV for the first time in 6 years. That three, the difference, 93-92. Fullerton State coming out on top. UNLV has now lost 6 games this year. 4 of them have been by 2 points or less. Elsewhere tonight, LaSalle and Lionel Simmons. Too much for Army. 88-67. LaSalle remaining on top of the Metro Atlantic and UTEP.
22 prior meetings before this evening. 83-80, Hill for three, no. Cedric Sebelos, no. Derrick Jones will try this time from three. Time running out, 83-83. They go to OT. Mark Hill with a three-pointer now. And it's 90-89 Titans. But the Rebels come back. David Butler. And it's a goaltend by John Sykes. Rebs lead by one. It's 92-90 now. John Sneed is bumming, but Stacy Augman is at the line. He throws up a brick. The iron was unkind. And then Wayne Williams up court. Count it. It's over. Titans win. Titans win. Holy cow. The Tark can't believe it as the Rebels go down. 93-92. Fullerton State had lost 15 times to the Rebs. They were 2-83 overall. The Rebels have now lost three of their last four games. Meanwhile, in the ACC, there was more civil war on Tobacco Road. NC State with their game home winning streak on the line, and J.R. Reed used the window pane there. Wolfpack, though, answers with three. Rodney Monroe knocks it down.
Take pillar end tables. Your choice, sale price $66 each. Or take the sofa table, sale price $77 each. The grand opening sale, only the furnishings, $2,000 nearest you.
Judo may be a competitive sport, but when Frank Sanchez teaches it, everyone's a winner. Frank has been a volunteer judo teacher at the East Valley Boys and Girls Club in Baldwin Park since 1981. He sees judo as a way to get boys and girls off the troubled streets and into the center.
Most important thing I want the kids to learn from judo is a self-respect, knowing that they can accomplish something on their own, find a goal for themselves and achieve it.
Discipline and values are taught along with judo skills. And Frank is often able to help with other problems at home or school as well. That's the spirit of Southern California. And Channel 4 salutes Frank Sanchez.
All right, Fred's here. An update on Magic now.
All right, how bad is Magic's injury? There is really no way of telling. He has a slight tear of the left hamstring. Optimistically, he'll be out 7 to 10 days. Realistically, no way of knowing when it will heal. The injury knocked him out of the All-Star game and put Kareem in. Today, the captain named to replace Magic. It will be his 19th All-Star appearance. Okay, tonight, Clippers put their one-game win streak on the line in Phoenix. First half, Clippers in red. Norm Nixon with a basketball inside here to Manoj Benjamin. Jump hook for Big Ben. He had a season-high 29, but it was not enough. Later in the game, Ken Norman had the ball for the Clippers. Of course, he went to Kevin Johnson of the Suns. Johnson, 14 assists in the first half, 18 in the game to Armand Gilliam for the Jam. Suns up by six. Later, Kevin Johnson watched this move here inside for the hoop. He had 34. Suns win at 120-113, and that snaps the Clippers' one-game winning streak. Running it out tonight, Washington, Charlotte, and Cleveland were winners. Chicago, Denver, and Dallas also picking up wins. Houston and Sacramento also victorious. Kings picked up the second half of the season where they left off the first. Here we go to the short rink at the Boston Garden. First period, no score. Bruins in white. Glenn Healy, Kings goalie, where are you going? Stay at home. Greg Johnson to Randy Burridge, open net. Burridge had the hat trick. Healy had a nightmare tonight. Now, later in the game, Bruins, Andy Buckley, watch him here performing a medical examination on Wayne Gretzky. Buckley said, Wayne, turn your head and cough, and then say, ah. We go to the third period, Kings down 2-0. John Tinelli, great effort, breaking through the defense, sliding the puck past Reggie Lemelin. That made it 2-1. Key play of the game, Gretzky breaking in here on Reggie Lemelin. He fired Lemelin, made the save. The Bruins beat the struggling Kings by a score of 4-1. When you get down to it, what can you really say about that?
The best answer is to make sure that a mess like this will never happen again.
Well, we certainly hope that's the case. Rounding it out, Calgary, New Jersey, and Hartford were winners, as were Pittsburgh and the Rangers. Edmonton, Minnesota also picking up victories. College basketball, one of the best finishes of the year in the UNLV Fullerton game. A last-second shot sent it into overtime, and a last-second shot won it. Great game. Here we go to Fullerton. Fullerton in white, down by three. You see the clock. Mark Hill firing for three to tie it. He missed. Cedric Sabalas grabbed it, fired for three to tie it. He missed. John Sykes the rebound out to Jerick Jones, who hit for three with 5 seconds left. We go into overtime, and Jerry Tarkanian, unfortunately on the bench, was going through some teething problems tonight. in overtime. Time is running out. UNLV down by two. Check that, up by two. It is freshman Wayne Williams stopping, popping, getting it to go. Fullerton with the three-pointer upsets 19th-ranked Las Vegas, 93-92. Missouri assistant Rich Daly filling in for Norm Stewart, who was hospitalized today. Strange scene at the Missouri-Oklahoma game. Sooners coach Billy Tubbs hit with a technical foul. Fans start to pelt the court with debris. The Oklahoma coach Tubbs grabs the PA microphone and ripped the referees in a unique way. Listen. No matter how bad the officiating, don't throw stuff. Another technical foul. But Oklahoma upset Missouri 112-105. Milestone in high school basketball. Tonight on our early show, we introduced you to Tracy Murray of Glendora. Tonight it is Glendora in black against Damien. The shot by Glendora is missed. Murray with the tip.
Mark Hill misses the three that would have tied it. Cedric Sabalos misses the three that would have tied it. Derek Jones, how about it? Yeah, and we're on to overtime. Tied at 83 apiece. And John Sneed of Cal State Fullerton at six. Cedric Hedick, number 119. His team down by two. Stacey Ogman misses the second foul shot. With 3 seconds left, Wayne Williams stops, pops. Yeah! Three-pointer. The Titans win it 93-92 in overtime, and the rough times continue for Jerry Tarkanian and the Running Rebs. Meanwhile, Michigan watched an 8.
Campus.
Well, you have a question off the top, huh?
Well, of course we have a question on Friday. Today, we start off with a consumer question. How fast do you think a 1989 Jaguar can travel on the open road?
Which state?
120 miles from off camera with David Horwitz.
He's everywhere, close. Isn't he?
He's everywhere. He's omnipresent.
Yeah, check your wallet.
Check your wallet. No. 125 miles per hour. That is how fast. Florida State Police clocked American League MVP Jose Canseco. He was pulled over on the Palmetto Expressway in Dade County at 1:25 a.m. when police spotted his red Jaguar zipping down the highway. Police said Canseco was cited for reckless driving but was very reasonable about it. He just accepted his ticket. What else could he do? College basketball fans got their money's worth last night in Fullerton. Cal State Fullerton upset 19th-ranked UNLV in overtime. Let us go to Fullerton. It's Fullerton White down by three. You see the clock. Mark Hill fired for three to tie the game at the end of regulation and missed. Cedric Sabalos grabbed it. He fired to tie it, and he missed. John Sykes the rebound out to Derek Jones, who hit for three with 5 seconds left. It's into overtime. And Jerry Tarkanian was so upset that he was teething on a sweaty towel. And believe you me, that's no joy. In overtime, time is running out. UNLV leading by two, but the freshman for Fullerton, Wayne Williams, stops, popped, it goes for three. And Fullerton beats 19th-ranked UNLV for the first time in nearly 6 years, 93-92. One of the great finishes in college basketball this season. Now, as we do each and every Friday at this time, let's look back at the memorable moments from the past week as we salute Rogan's Heroes, and we will start at the LA Open with the chip shot of the week. Steve Pate, all turns, fires, length of the court, off the glass, he got it to go. That is an incredible shot. Best team effort by the Warriors, Manute Bol, the block of Tom Garrick's shot, Bol to Rod Higgins, his pass was saved by Steve Alford, Alford to Larry Smith, Smith gave it to Mitch Richmond for the layup. Pass of the week, it is Charles Oakley of the Knicks. A long pass, whipping it down to Mark Jackson. Great pass here, hike between his legs to Gerald Wilkins, who scored against the Bullets. And that even impressed Carly Simon. In tennis, it's 16-year-old Michael Chang with the shot of the week against Hugo Chapacu of Paraguay. Chapacu back and forth along the baseline, tried to drop the shot in, but Chang racing to the net, making the return. Chapacu couldn't get it back. And that was a shot that mom and dad were proud of. In hockey, the save of the week by New Jersey, Sean Burke. Craig McTavish came in the shot, but Burke, a beautiful save from close range. Check of the week was in Boston as Ken Linsman put Pittsburgh's John Cullen up, over, and back. And finally, the knockout of the week, it is Jerry Jones in the black trunks teaching Michael Bent a lesson in his first pro fight. Look out for the left. Look out for the left. Down he goes. And, sir, what did you think of Rogan's Heroes? Well, you can't please all the people all the time. I have that effect on people, unfortunately. Have a nice weekend. Sunday night, a special edition of Rogan's Heroes Best Basketball Shots for the first half of the season.
All right. Sounds good. All right. Thanks, Fred.
Thank you, Fred.
Be warned, the danger of rape exists on campus. Rape by someone they know or by stranger. Critics say most colleges fail to warn students and many now are being sued for negligence.
These lawsuits have really established certain legal standards. One is that colleges have a duty to protect students.
2 years ago, Gail Barbanel, director of the Santa Monica Rape Treatment Center, noticed a dramatic increase in reported campus rape cases. To protect young students, Barbanel wrote this report. It urges administrators to begin educational programs, increase security, and establish victims' assistance. 2 years ago, the University of California at Berkeley was called a dangerous campus in a national survey. Administrators cracked down.
Specifically, we've seen a decrease in sexual assaults from 1986, when we had 11 reported to the police department, to 8 and now 7 for 1988.
About the same time, at UCLA in Los Angeles, panic spread.